Hello, Wargamers, and welcome to today's Warhammer 40K Battle Report. I am Luka from MiniWarGaming.com, joined today by Rob from Team Drew's Basement. Check them out if you haven't already. They have a lot of Warhammer 40K content as well on their channel, as general nerdery included along with it. Today, we're doing 1,500 points of the Word Bears against the Space Wolves in a Tempest of War match.
We play and call it work.
MiniWarGaming's Warhammer 40K Battle Report.
Today's Word Bearer list will be very familiar to what I've run in the past, except 1,500 points now, because they keep reducing the points of everything. A 2,000 point game was a 3,000 point game at the start of the edition. So, 1,500 points to find the happy medium here. It is mostly the 30K Word Bearer collection, but a lot of it fits very well in Warhammer 40K. Our general, our warlord in this Arcs of Omen detachment will be our Dark Apostle. He will be an apostle of the Dark Council. Couldn't actually afford to give him the Mark of Slaanesh today. So that's a good thing. You know, it goes to show you have to make some hard choices. I did give him a Gift of Chaos, so he'll have two relics today. And that will be the Epistle of Lorgar. So he's got a nice little leaflet spreading the good word. And he'll be equipped with the eightfold Cursed Crozius. He'll know Illusory Supplication as well as Omen of Potency. And his warlord trait, well, he'll be lucky enough to be exalted in his possession. So he's got increased characteristics. Along with him, we're going to run a Master of Possession who will be marked by Tzeentch, giving him access to this specific spell, as well as actually, mostly just that, and the mark effect too. He'll know two powers from the Malefic Discipline, Cursed Earth, as well as Pact of Flesh. It's always hard to choose what artifact to give him. I am spending a command point on Gift of Chaos to give him an artifact, so eating up, you know, five of my command points here. We're going to go with the Liber Hereticus in today's game. Moving on to troops, I have three units of Legionnaires here. With a variety of weapons, they're all free now. So I got a couple Power Fists, I got a Demonic Blade in there, and two squads are running Melta Guns, and one squad's gonna have a Plasma Gun. I kinda wish the squads with Melta Guns could have been Chainswords and Bolt Pistols. That's where the 30K collection lacks. It doesn't have any despoilers. It only has regular Tactical Marines. Oh well, it is what it is. It shouldn't make that big of a difference. Then the rest of my troops will be Cultist Mobs. I am running two units of 10 with Heavy Stubbers, and then one unit of 20 that will be equipped with their Brutal Assault weapons and a couple Flamers. However, the champion is going to have a Trophy of the Long War, and that will be, naturally, the Black Rune of Damnation. Moving on to Elites, it's kind of hard to play Word Bearers without some Demonic Possession, so we got two units of 5 Possessed. I will be running a Venom Crawler for the first time in a while, so this is on Len from the Black Legion. And then we have a squad of 5 Havocs with the Mark of Tzeentch, and they are going to all be running Laz Cannons. And then I have a unit of 3 Obliterators, which I think is a little too heavy-handed in this list. I did want to change this up last minute, but I decided to stick with the decision and just run with it and see how well they do for me. It's a little bit too many points invested in one unit for my liking, if you guys know what I'm saying. Anyways, that's it for my list. Let's go take a look at what the Space Wolves are bringing today.
All right, so Rob here from Team Drew's Basement. So far, 1,500 points of Space Wolves ended up being with a list of 1,495, just to fit everything in that I needed. But we're starting off with Bjorn the Fell-Handed with a Hellfrost Cannon, Heavy Flamer, and True Claw. We have the Primaris Chaplain on Bike next with a Master of Sanctity. He has the Litanies of Exhortation of Rage and Canticle of Hate, the Relic of the Wolfenstone, and he also has a Warlord trait of Saga of the Wolfkin. A lot of my characters are eating up a lot of my points, or my command points this game, but at the same time it helps them buff everybody else in the rest of the army, so I'm here for it. We have the Wolf Lord on Thunderwolf with Thunderhammer Storm Shield. He has the Warrior of Legends, so he's taking the Warlord traits, Saga of the Hunter and Saga of the Warrior Born, and no relics on him. For our troops, we have 3 units of Blood Claws, all basically kitted out the same with Bolt Pistols and Chain Swords, with one guy in each squad having a Plasma Pistol, and each of the sergeants have Power Fists. Next up, we have the Blade Guard Veterans, all kitted out as they come. We have Murder Fang, who it comes as he is as well. And we have the Wolf and Dreadnought with the Fenrisian Great Axe and Blizzard Shield. And to round out the rest of the army, we have three fast attack units, specifically the Thunderwolf Cavalry, with the Sergeant having a Thunderhammer Storm Shield, and the other two in that unit having Lightning Claws and Storm Shields. And to round out the rest, we have two units of Fenrisian Wolves. One squad is a 5-man with a Cyberwolf, and the other unit is 8-man Fenrisian Wolves.
Today's mission, taken hold, very simple. It will be starting the second battle round, getting 5 victory points for each condition, 1 objective, 2 objectives, and more than your opponent. So that's like right under the Eternal War stuff, and there's nothing else to it. You can cap it at 45 points for that from the second to the fifth battle round. The rest of your points are going to be coming from the secondary mission cards in Tempest of War. So it's kind of random, and you got to do what the cards say. Now, our mission rule is actually chilling rain. So it's just kind of cold and wet, but overall, no adverse effects. Our deployment is going to be a search and destroy style table. As you can see here, one player will be deploying on one quadrant as the opponent will be deploying opposite. And then there's a little circle in the middle of no man's land with the appropriate unrepresented quadrants also counting towards that. We decided to put one objective directly in the middle to represent the importance of the bridge. Because it's a take and hold style mission, the locations are what are the important parts of the battlefield. So the stairs covering the escape or access to the rest of the parts of the battlefield, the bridges are important, and just overall, generally, every little part of this is important around those objectives. And whoever can control them for the longest will be the winner. I just wanted to show off the table a little bit here today because Rob and I have decided to play with something a little bit more extravagant and has some elevation. However, if this is a 6-foot by 4-foot table, we are still cutting off 6 inches on this side and then 6 inches on the other side. That way it's 60 inches lengthwise. You could cut off 2 inches over here, but it's often never really worth it. I'll try to avoid using it. And we'll see if it matters or not later throughout this game. We have our 5 objectives. This one is in a deployment zone. No man's land, no man's land, no man's land, and then that one's in the deployment zone over there. The board here, it's a multi-section board. It was made by Admac Greenleaf Terrain. He's local. He makes a lot of the terrain for us. You can check him out in the description down below. He's a very skilled individual and makes very beautiful tables. This is his work from about 10 years ago, just to give you like an idea of, and he's grown in skill as well since then. So go check him out there if you want. Otherwise, the rest of the terrain here is just the new Games Workshop kits for their ruins, which work really well for the game, and some Imperial statuary too from Games Workshop there. We're gonna go ahead and roll off to see who's playing on what side. I do wanna say that we decided the canal is gonna be impassable. The bridges are gonna be the only ways to get across, unless you have fly. You can obviously jump over the canal in that way. So I'm gonna roll a 4. And Rob got a 5 actually, nice. So all the power to Rob.
I'll choose this side.
You wanna go over there?
Yeah.
5 for you, well, okay, easy enough, I appreciate that. So we are gonna go ahead and deploy our forces. Though I do wanna remind everyone watching that if you wanna come by and play some war games with me here at Mini Wargaming or anyone here at Mini Wargaming, go to miniwargaming.com/challenge and we'll be happy to accommodate. I will play literally any game if we got the time to do it, but we really need Age of Sigmar right now. That's typically what we're always looking for. Don't know why, but it is. It is what it is. If you want to play 40K, you're more than welcome to come. There'll just be a longer wait. Anyways, Rob and I are going to go ahead and deploy our forces, and we'll get this game going. There, we have occupied the battlefield here today. So we'll go over my deployments here. We're just going back and forth. Cultists near this objective behind the ruined walls. I got some Legionnaires with a plasma gun and our Possessed also hanging out there. And then if anyone's curious, the 9 was around here, so we're both 9 away from about 18 inches in the middle. More Legionnaires, more cultists, but I put a lot of my stuff on this side. So we got our Warlord, the Dark Apostle, with our Master of Possessions, the Venom Crawler, as well as the other Possessed. Havocs with the Mark of Zinj up in the ruins there, covering both this objective and that objective, though it's all dense terrain on that objective, so it's all negative when I hit over there. Unfortunately, they can't really see through this too much to get to that objective, but they're a Havoc, so they're a little bit more mobile without having to take the negative to hit. And then as like a little backup over here, just on the edge of the battlefield, I have unit of Legionnaires that are ready to kind of pop up and get over there when the timing is right. I got my cultists back here acting as just the thing to watch as back objective because I don't get sticky objectives. That's pretty much it for myself. I, of course, have the Obliterators in reserve, ready to show up where and when needed if it comes up. And then on Rob's side of the battlefield, what do we got over here? We got Thunderwolves, our Wolf Priest on bike. And then we have our trio of Dreadnoughts, all of them together, Bjorn, the Wolf and Dreadnought, and the Murderfang?
Murderfang,
yeah. Fenrisian Wolves, Bloodclaws. Fenrisian Wolves, Bloodclaws. Bloodclaws. Bladeguard veterans in the ruins there with the Wolf Lord. The Wolf Lord's back here, right? Yeah, there he is. Yep. So both the characters back here with the Thunderwolf Cavalry. And that is it. That is it. So the Wolves are marching. And they're going to meet me in the middle. I'm not too sure what to do with the Dreadnoughts. I have the Obliterators, but the Obliterators are unreliable at the best of times. So we'll see. I mean, in my experience, I know they're typically not that bad, but man, they can be suspect at best. Okay, that is it. We're going to roll out to see who has to go first. We are playing Tempest of War, so it's all about the cards and where they lay when they're played. All right, so you go ahead and roll a die. I'm not quite ready for mine, but I'll grab mine in a second. You got four. What do I get? I'm going to get a two. So that means I'm going second as the Word Bearers. I'm also starting with zero command points. Again, a reminder, he's got four of them. The Cultists have one of them, and the Master of Possessions has the sixth one. And I believe Rob is starting with one.
That's correct.
But we're going up a command point each now.
Yes.
So yeah, if anyone's curious, we're playing Tempest of War, but we're using the Arcs of Omen rules because they are pretty good, all things considered. Use this to keep track of the score. The D10s will track our primaries. I'll be the enemy on the right, and then Rob will be the Space Wolves with the blue and the green die on the left there. That's our current command points in the first battle round. We're going to draw some cards for Rob and see what he gets, though. We're drawing some pretty suspect cards here. Sorry for the shadows here, guys. Storm hostile objective on turn one means take my home objective. Kill my character with assassination, or kill one of them, and then bring it down against the Word Bearers. In this case, would be the Venom Crawler is the goals for the secondaries. Not much to do in the command phase here, other than litanies, of course, on our Wolf Priest. What are we thinking?
Yeah, so we're going to do the Litany of Hate on the Wolves.
Boop, boop, boop. This is the reroll aura. Boom.
Boom. So I just reroll it again?
No, you're good. Yeah, the aura works. Yeah, it just doesn't target things specifically. It's just an aura of rerolls. Characters and core get to reroll all hit rolls, which is pretty good for Wolves. Anyways, that is, I guess, it, really. We're going to move everything. I'm going to show you where it all ends up. It's all kind of melee-focused, so we're going to be doing a lot of scrapping. Though I'm a cheese lord and I brought some heavy weapons, so I'll be firing them at least a little bit, too. I feel bad. I hate bringing shooting attacks, but, like, sometimes it just works out that way. All right, so the Thunder Wolf moving up, seeing behind the ruins here. The Wolf Lord and the Wolf Priest catching up. All the Dreadnoughts forming a back line following the Fenrisian Wolves and all the Blood Claws advancing. We do get the Blade Guard veterans and the Wolf Guard battle leader up near the objective there. So they are going to be threatening that. And of course, on this side, the Fenrisian Wolves ran towards that objective. So I will have to push you off of these. We got two units of Blood Claws up there supporting those Fenrisian Wolves. Putting pressure on the objectives early, doing what you can. The objectives you drew for the secondary aspect, kind of buns, but whatever. Like, it's okay to drop bad ones off the rip. That's it for moving. There is no Rune Priest, so we are going to go on to shooting where we have it. Bjorn is going to fire his Hellfrost Cannon into the Legionnaires you can see in the ruins.
Heavy D3 to see how many shots I do.
One shot. I assume it's a blast, but in this case, it's only blast. He hits on twos because he's Bjorn, probably.
Strength six.
Yeah.
Yeah, twos.
Does he hit?
No.
Anytime it rolls in a little pothole, we're going to have to call cocked. That's it. Hit, though. And strength six, three to wound. That is a wounding hit.
Taco Cat.
What is the AP on this bad boy?
AP minus two.
Normally?
Yes.
Yeah, so it should be a heavy weapon, so it should be AP three in this case. Two up save while in cover, so, haha, that's not gonna help. Is that two damage?
One damage.
Oh. I guess it's just the Bjorn's gun. It's not like he take too many great options, he just takes like a basic Dreadnought heavy weapon. But man, that D3 shots, I feel like that one should be three shots. Anyways. In the end, we take a damage. And is that it for shooting?
Unless the wolf.
That would be it for shooting, just because this big ruin is mostly blocking line of sight both ways there. That is it. No secondaries being scored. Just looking at all the objectives, just because I know what they are, I can kind of counterplay against them. So you never really want to keep them unless you can guarantee get them on the next turn. So you think about getting rid of all of them?
Getting rid of all of them.
Yeah, so all three are gone. We're going to draw new ones up next turn, and we're going to go on to turn one for the Word Bearers here. Nothing crazy for score yet. It's a pretty tame game. I'm just going to build up my command points for a bit before I start using them. All right, so we're going to draw Blood and Guts. That is kill three units in the assault phase. We have to extend our battle lines, which is overall pretty easy, and a tempting target as our last one. Rob, tempting target, which of these three objectives do you want me to go for?
I'm going to change my answer from what I said before. I'm going to go with that one.
Want me to take that objective up there? Well, that will be difficult. okay. Extend battle lines. I have to control this objective and any one of these three. So if I go for that one, that's a two for one over there. But that's also like next to impossible. So I don't even think anything I have can get over there this turn. So I'll probably have to extend battle lines on this objective, which is what the cultists are for. And attempting target won't be able to do and kill three things in melee. That's probably not going to happen until turn two or three. So that one's probably scuffed as well. But hey, I'll get the one, I guess. That's a good start. In my command phase, I have some litanies to inspire. And by litanies, I mean
prayers
to the dark gods, yes. Start with the tried and true illusory supplication. Now, he essentially, with all his upgrades, he gets to reroll his prayer rolls because he's part of the Dark Council. He's also leadership 11. And then he's got the Epistle of Lorgar, which lets him chant an additional prayer and know an additional prayer. So he's a pretty good Dark Apostle. So he's like the Master of Sanctity, kind of. Mm-hmm. So he is going to do the Illusory Supplication on a 2-up. It worked. It's on 2s because he's got the two little homies there. Once they die, they're back to 3s. So what that does is I pick a unit nearby. In this case, I'm going to pick the Cultists, and I double the amount of models in the unit because I make little clones of them. But what that means mechanically is you can only hit them on 4s, no rerolling, because you might be hitting a fake one every time you roll the hit. And then he's going to chant Omen of Potency on himself, which is a 5, which he just increases his strength attacks and AP, I believe. It might just be attacks and AP. It just makes him more powerful in melee. Not that it's going to matter too much, but just in case. And then we're going to go on a movement. I'm going to start with moving my... In fact, I'm only really going to move these cultists, I think. Yeah. I'm going to keep all these guys still. All this is going to stay still. Just the cultists are going to advance an extra 6. Ooh, they're eager. They're just going to move towards the objective, having a few of them in range of it, but holding the line on the bridge. They're going to stay still because I don't know what I want them to do yet. I could send them out to go fight Bladeguard veterans, but I think they will die. So no, I'm going to hold both my possessed for like turn 3, 4, or 5 fighting after the dust settles and I throw the crap at the enemy enough that they're weaker. The possessed can then go bully the weak enemies. Hopefully. We are going to move our Dark Apostle. We're going to run him. We're going to run him. I do want to get up the field with him. I'm not going to go the full distance, though. I'm going to go... Because he moves 8 with his Exalted Possession. He goes up to 11. But I want to keep him what the minimum run for the cultists is going to be. So I'm going to keep him kind of within 7 of them. But realistically, he moves 8. There's no point in running him. But I'll keep the run just in case, I guess. He'll move up the field there. Then we're going to run our horde of cultists there in the middle. Advancing them an extra 6. Ooh, nice. They get to go pretty far. Zealous. Yes. They are going to make their way to wherever they can, actually. They could be annoying on the middle objective and try and steal that, but that's not the tempting target. That's the problem. Massive 12-inch move. We're going to have a few of them come towards this objective to take it away and deny it because they are OBSEC. Mm-hmm. And then the rest are going to make their way towards that objective. Can't get it, though, because it is a little out of reach, and they're going to surround the Dark Apostle to keep him a little protected. Again, there's many cultists there. They are under the effects of illusory supplication. I am going to move... This squad of Marines is going to run, or advance. They're going to go an additional 5. They're going to go climb up. This, we're going to end up around here. Move up to there, then the Venom Crawler scuttles 12 inches that direction. We are going to advance our Master of Possessions. So he's going to move up to about here to keep up with the scuttling Venom Crawler. And then our Possessed are going to advance as well. Sure. They both go 2, actually. And that's where they both end up, putting a lot of pressure on the middle bridge and the further bridge there. Not quite getting towards that objective now, but really thinking about putting some pressure on it. We are going to move on to the psychic phase for our Master of Possessions and see what he can accomplish. Libra Hereticus can do 3 powers, apparently. This is a pretty good relic for him. So I don't even know. First power was going to be Cursed Earth. I'm sorry, I didn't even declare it. So we will get a +1 of that roll, so we get on a 9. So it's a little aura of 4 of invulnerable save. For demons and demonkin, so increasing their saves there. And if you charge them, you take mortal wounds. And then the other one is going to be smite, I guess. We got it with the 10. So it's going to do D3 mortal wounds to the wolves, because they're the Fenrisian wolves, they're the nearest. So they are going to suffer 2 mortal wounds, which will just kill 2 of the wolves from my brain bullets. And then the last one, because he can do 3 powers, there is nothing else I can guess. I can give them an invulnerable save, but there's nothing really shooting at them, so I don't need to. Nothing with AP that would get through their save anyway, so I won't even risk the perils. We're okay there. I gave him the Mark of Zinch so that he could give them an invulnerable save in this list if I needed to, keeping him nearby with the Libra Hereticus, making it longer range. that in mind, we're going to go into the shooting phase, and we're going to go right to the Havocs. They're going to shoot four of their las cannons into no real options, really. The only thing I can shoot at, because that building right there, I can't see down this lane with them. I can see that objective and that objective. So I'm going to shoot over this way. I am going to shoot at the Blood Claws, the ones nearest to me, I guess. I am shooting through negative one to hit, though, and they're going to have light cover because they're on the bridge. So not great shots, but they are still shots. Need fours to hit. I am going to get one hit. Be a two to wound. That is going to not count. That's going to be a two. These are AP 3, but you'll have pretty good saves all around. So up to you, wherever you want to take it. D6 damage, though. One regular Blood Claw with light cover will have a 5-up save.
Nope.
Oh, he might not die. D6 damage, he is dead. He gets pierced by a las cannon. That's it. That's not true. I got the Venom Crawler to shoot. He's got the Venom Crawler firing. He's going to be firing through dense terrain here, so Excruciator Cannons into... I'll shoot that front squad of Blood Claws there. Why not? I could go for the dog. No, I'll go for the Blood Claws. 6 shots with this Excruciator Cannon. We have 3 hits. And they're assault, so the 6s don't matter yet. And these are 3s to wound. 3 wounds, minus 2. Let me reroll that. I forgot the negative 1 to hit aspect of it. Okay, let me reroll. Okay, I got 2 hits, 2 wounds. Okay, we're still good. You have 4 ups on the regular guys, or 3 ups on the Terminator.
Let's go Terminator.
Terminator! He is good and good. Terminator armor keeping him alive. And that's it for shooting. Charge. I'll declare a charge with the Venom Crawler into the Fenrisian Wolves, I guess. Even though he can consolidate, he can heroically intervene in me, eh?
That's correct.
But I get to go first.
Right.
That's great, I'll charge. See what I get. Nope, 4. I'm not going to bother rerolling. I will end my turn there. And that is it. Scoring secondaries. All I really get is a extend battle lines here and there. It only counts for 1 score, though. But I got two places I could score. I am going to get... Do I want to keep tempting target? I think I want to keep tempting target because it stays the same. It will be that one forever. And then kill 3 things in melee. We're kind of getting there. We are getting there. So I think I want to keep that as well, weirdly enough. But I will score the 1. That means I'm only drawing 1 card next turn. Throwing off the score a little bit, I do have 1 secondary scored for 5 points. Each one's always worth 5 points, unless it says otherwise. And then 10 points for Rob, because he's on 2 of the objectives, but not more than me. 2 being this one. Sorry, that one. And the one in your territory. And I got the 3 here. But that's at the end of the phase. Technically, just showing it off now. And then we got litanies to do. First, how about cards for Rob here? So, drawing behind enemy lines, that's having 2 of your units wholly within my deployment zone. That's probably not going to happen this turn because I got it all screened out. The second one is extend battle lines, but we drew deploy teleport homers, which is like the same thing as behind enemy lines. But Rob spent 1 of his 4 command points going down to 3 to draw extend battle lines, which is the one I just accomplished. And then secure no man's land has had 2 objectives in no man's land. Also, kind of doable. Though, you have to fight through some cultists. Like, it's either fight these cultists, which is much easier than... These ones are way easier to kill than those ones are, that's right. For sure. But yes. either one of them is doable, so something to look forward to. We'll see some cultists die this turn, because the Thunderwolf can... Obviously, I want the Thunderwolf to come in so I can countercharge, but we'll see how that goes. Oh, I forgot to shoot these guys. I don't actually care, so I'm not going to bother. The thing I do care about that I will do, though, is his third power, he could cast Pact of Flesh to heal that guy, which he would... It just heals his 1 wound. Now on to the Litanies over here.
So we're going to do the Wolf Priest... And he's going to cast, or he's going to do the litany for Canticle of Hate on the Thunderwolf Calf.
Thunderwolves, that is good to go.
Good to go. And then he's also going to do Exhortation of Rage on them also.
It's okay, we've got a 4. That is plus 2 to their charge rolls and increases their consolidation moves, which, you know, Thunderwolf do that also, so that's nice. I don't know if those 2 stack, but they might. And then the other one is plus 1 to wound, so they are going to charge into my cultists, smash through them, and then consolidate into my guys back there. On to movement, our Blade Guard friends are going to start cleaving through some cultists. Then next up, our Blood Claws are moving forward to attempt and in an attempt to secure the objective. So the Wolves are going to come up as well, then the Blood Claws, and these ones are coming up in a round. And then we got some more moves over here.
The Blood Claws, these Blood Claws are going to run.
Running them. Ooh, nice. Not quite getting to the objective, eh? Only rolled a 2. Nice.
Only rolled 2.
It's probably Rob's 8th 2 for advanced rolls so far. You guys missed him in the first movement phase, but everything rolled a 2 except for the Wolfguard Battle Leader back there, who is the lieutenant for the Blade Guard veterans. Yeah, space wolves just have fancy names for everything. Technically, they're not named that anymore, but I don't want the tradition to die because the space wolves have to be extra. Up and around come our Thunder Wolf Cavalry. And up comes the Wolf Lord and the Wolf Priest. Oh, we are going to be tangoing for a bit over here. And so does Murder Fang. And the two heftier dreadnoughts are moving up the middle. This is going to be waves and waves of bloodshed here, guys. Then the Fenrisian wolves in the back spreading out to deny any real good placement of the obliterators back there. We're right on the shooting. We got a lot of little arms fire. Kind of everywhere.
Bolt pistols first. So four heavy bolt pistols into the cultist.
And forced hit, because I'm a cultist. That there's a lot of, hey, look, all three hit. Nice. And then these are forced wound, because I'm negative one wound. Black and damnation, two of them. I'm going to blow two of them dead, so I'll remove them, I guess, now.
Cry for the sergeant.
Oh, and there's two neo-volkites. You might as well roll them both at the same time, because it's all forced to hit. That's two hits. And then these, you want sixes, essentially, for the mortal wounds. There we go. That does a mortal wound in addition to the normal damage. That'll be, and cultists don't get to ignore the mortal wounds. That'll be four damage on the cultist so far.
There's my pistol in there.
And to keep it simple for myself, I'm just going to remove cultists over here.
Yep.
Because I need these ones to die first. I need these ones to stay alive.
Yeah.
And I need to stay on the objective.
Because the pistols are 12.
So we got one pistol from the blood claws back here firing. It's a hit. And
three.
No. It's forced wound. Minus one to wound. The black rune of damage.
And these guys can shoot those.
Yes. We got the three pistols and one plasma. So the pistols, we got a hit and a wound, and then throw the plasma in there as well. Hit and a wound. Nice. I think I get a six up against the pistol. Didn't matter there. And then I'll lose these two. Bloop, bloop.
Out.
And then we got some more, a couple more shots. These guys advanced, so no shooting on them, but we got these two here.
Stormbolter.
Yep, he should be good. Rapid firing.
Yep, rapid.
Shots from the Wolf and Dread on fours. One hit. And wound as well. That's a dead cultist, and then we have Bjorn. I'm just gonna pull him from, I guess I'll pull the cultist. We'll say that guy dies.
Burn frost cannon.
Oh, frost and who? The cultist?
Or
you can go for these guys again.
Yeah, I can go for those guys again.
Or you can go do some shots. Oh, that's in the way. Yeah, you can go for those again. Yep. D3 shots, one shot. Does hit, and does it wound? Nope.
Yeah.
Moving over to the frag grenade from Thunderwolf into the cultist. They did not advance, they just moved. That's gonna be five shots, nice. These hit on threes, because they are not under the effects of supplication, three hits. Not that there's any threes there. Forced wound, that is gonna be one, which I should get a six up against, which I do not make. Ah! And bolt rifle from the Wolf Priest in the back. That is, does he hit on twos? He used to be twos and threes and twos, now he's, I think, twos and twos. Only hits on threes for shooting. He practices his speeches in melee too much. And a couple wounds. No save on that. That's AP2. Blah, blah. Floor, it's a little too far to throw a grenade. So we're probably on the charging now.
Yes.
The charging, the Blade Guard will start this show off. Let's see what they get. They're going to get another 10 on the charge, so they're good to go. Fighting on the bridge. Okay, do you want to charge over here?
I was going to do the wolves next.
Oh, yeah, that works too. The Fenrisian wolves declaring charge. That's going to be a six and something. And that's
six.
More.
Yeah, it's seven.
More than enough to get in there. These blood claws are going to declare charge in the Venom Crawler. Nice.
Five.
They are going to make that charge. Nice.
Venom Crawler?
Get more blood claws coming from the Venom Crawler.
Four.
That might that will require a reroll if you want to commit them in there. Otherwise. That's one CP for a reroll. That's a five. Sorry, other dice over here, guys. Boom. Needed a six on the dice. They're just outside of the 5-inch charge. So these blood claws are charging under the Venom Crawler unsupported. That's okay. They don't necessarily need support. They are blood claws after all. They can and will get the job done. All right, that is it for charging on that side. We do have the Thunder Wolves who get plus two to their charge for the Litany. So they're going to roll up that's a six. That's good enough. Charge like that just to make room for the characters to maybe charge in if you want the character. Well, yeah, definitely want the character support. So who's first?
Oh, we'll go with the chap.
Chaplain. Boom, boom, boom. Nice, seven. We'll be a fail on him. And then the Wolf Lord could attempt it. A six, no. All right. Well, I didn't really need their help anyways. How to start?
Oh, we'll start here with the Venom Crawler.
Then, yeah, it makes sense. I'm not going to interrupt with the cultist, right? So right. I might use it. Let me double check a few things here. Oh, you have to, you do take mortal wounds for charging him because of the cursed earth. It's not a lot. It's like a mortal wound, but let me roll it out. Because on a one, it's nothing. That's just a mortal wound. Boop. Save my CP for the Demon Engine here. It's just one unit fighting me. I should be okay-ish. So pile in and roll it up. Let's see how many. You want to do the Thunderhammer first?
Thunderhammer first.
T Hammer first. You're hitting on threes again because you're a wolf. I got two hits. Not bad. And then these are threes to wound. That's a pair of wounds. I'm going to go AP 2. I have a 3 up to a 5 up, but I have Cursed Earth, so it augments my invulnerable save by 1. So I just have a 4 up. I have to re-roll that because I rolled
them.
Actually, they both went in there. Come on. I don't. Table. Make one, fail one. Look at that. This, which is the same result as that.
So it's 3 damage.
3 damage. I take 3. And then we have a lot of chainsword attacks. Blood Claws are special. They get an extra attack for charging because of Berserk Charge. And then the Power Fist is next. Should be 4 attacks here. I probably should have reduced the damage I take by 1 because of the Power Fist and Thunderhammer, but we're fine. Well, saving command points. 1 miss, 3 hits. And these are 3s to wound because he's strength 8. 1. Okay. Right to my invulnerable save, which we're good. The chain swords are revving up and swinging. Those are going to be also 4 attacks each because blood claws, chain swords, shock assault. So 12 attacks in total. 12 attacks on 2s, plus 1 to hit for chain swords. Pretty good for wolves. 5s to wound here. That is, quite a bit. Not enough to kill me though. Got 4 ups. I take 3 more damage. I've taken 6 in total and 3 remaining wounds left. And if anyone's curious, I didn't hero claim to be because that's where you piled into. I couldn't do that after the pile in. All right, I will attack back with nothing, because you still have to resolve your other charges.
Yeah.
The blade guards are charging in, swords drawn, and for the All-Father, they scream as they cut down some cultists. 4 attacks each on the charge. It's going to be 21 attacks. 4 is to hit, because there's a lot of cultists. Illusory Supplication, that is, and no rerolls either. But half miss. And then here's, these are normally 3s to wound, but these are 4s to wound because of Black Rune. So cultists, like 4s and 4s, essentially. Not bad. You can reroll that one there, yeah. All right. Is gonna kill 8 more of my cultists. So I'm just gonna pull. That's a tough one. Because they are, even up to the object, they're still near my deployment zone, but they're not gonna be near this guy. Do I wanna give up the objective? Let me see here. I think I wanna keep these guys on the objective over there, so I'm gonna lose 4. And then 5, 6, 7, 8. I am losing the champion here, so I'm losing the Black Rune of Damnation, but that's okay. Because I'll just bring it back. if they live. I still have to survive the Fenrisian Wolves. Fenrisian Wolves are going to pile in. I have to hope they can't kill 5 more cultists. The Black Rune Damnation is dead, but the Illusory Supplication is still in play. Hang on, 4s with the Fenrisian Wolves. Quite a bit of attacks, though. Ooh. It's only 4 hits. That means I'm going to live no matter what. And probably 3s to kill, because I don't have my Black Rune anymore. So I kill 3 more of them. 3 more die. So 1, 2, a 3. Boop. There we go. Over to this side here. I'm gonna let you pile in. So this guy effectively would go like there, that guy would go there, and then they'd make a triangle. Yeah, get a little bit closer, getting base contact. Tech, boom, 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 boom. Oh, I guess it'd be with the mod. It doesn't really matter. It's all the same there. It doesn't matter the position of them. I'm just gonna go ahead and
take them out.
They're dead. You got them. They are dead. And then they get to consolidate up to 6 because of the one ability. You could engage these guys, which allows them to fight back, or you can just stay in enjoy. Up to you. Not gonna bother engaging because I do have a Power Fist and there would be free Power Fist swings. I've been consolidated a little bit just to screen me away from the objective so that I have to like charge them to get on the objective. So I don't want to kill them fully, but I want to kill them somewhat. That way I can't just freely walk up to the objective. Okay, that's it for fighting there. I get to retaliate. I'm not gonna bother attacking with those cultists. They're not gonna do anything. I will attack with a Venom Crawler though. He's gonna attack with his Soul Flayer tendrils and claws. There's 6 of them. 6 attacks! 3s to hit, but we're a word bearer! So we reroll hit rolls. Woo! Oh, it didn't matter. Okay, 4 hits. 3s to wound. 4 wounds. That looked like it was somehow 4 ones, and then it immediately flipped to all wounds. I double checked the clip, maybe I'm seeing things, but like as they were rolling in the air, it looked like there was like 4 ones, and then it was like, boom, everything's good. maybe I watched dice roll too much in my life. I don't know. Terminator. Did the Terminator want to eat these?
Yeah, we'll have the Terminator eat them.
All right, so 1 at a time. You can do 2 at a time.
This guy was already hurt.
Oh, he's got to take the hits first. Sorry. So yeah. Minus 3, he's got 6 up save. First one, he dramatically is going to die. He gets impaled by a claw and thrown to the side. And then we have a few more saves. 2 at a time on the Terminator. He's got invulns. He'll take 2 damage, and then he'll have some wounds left. And then he tanks it. Nice. So we kill 1 of them and wound the Terminator down to 1. That should conclude it. I wanted to get some damage on those Fenrisian Wolves, but my cultist got the beat it up real bad there. Okay. That will be it for the turn. Morale, I definitely have to check on the cultists. I'll probably save the CP and risk it, because I'm going to run automatic, unless I roll a 1. They lost 2 minutes. The leadership 11 on the Apostle of the Dark Council. Out of range, maybe, but it wouldn't really matter here. I lost 18 cultists. I'm gonna roll it just to show how good the morale system is for 9th edition Warhammer 40K. Lost 18 of my models, and I'm gonna lose one of them here. So I lost one of them. And then on a 1 or 2, the other cultist is gonna run away. On a 3, if I keep him. Oh, okay, he runs away. It was worth the risk. I was thinking about using the 2 command points there. It would have gave me an extra 5 victory points. But I kind of wanted the command points or something else on my turn, so I figured I'd risk it. On a 3 up, on a 1 and then a 3 up, he was going to live. And then I could bring D6 plus 3 back a turn. I'd say D3 plus 3, but they are dead. Bye-bye. One runs, and then one runs away. Oh, gosh. But the fact that they could have stayed is, I think, ludicrous. And that will conclude the turn. Now we're going to look at some scoring. You control all 3 of the objectives in the middle, which means you are going to get secured no man's land and extended battle lines. That'll be 2 secondary scored there. The other one you were trying to do was get behind enemy lines, which is get 2 units wholly within my territory. Not quite here, because my territory is like starting at this point here. Yeah, about here, actually. So the unit has to be wholly within it, and it ends kind of like where the objective is. So no one's quite in the territory yet, but they're working on it. But I think you said you want to get rid of it?
Yeah. Yep, can get rid of it.
But you still get the 2 scored ones. Now, unfortunately, I only do get 5 victory points that turn. It was arguably worth keeping those cultists around, because I'd be at 15 victory points this turn. No, I'd only be at 10, so it's not too bad, actually. Currently, the Space Wolves have taken the lead. I'm only at 10 victory points, whereas they're at 20, because each one of these is worth 5, sorry. That's math. All right, we still have Blood and Guts and a Tempting Target from last turn, but I can feasibly get them this turn. Blood and Guts will be a little bit of a stretch, but I can work towards it. And then Raise Banners is my new card. That's going to be tough. Tempting Target, I just have to fight for that objective, which is kill everything around it, essentially. Which is going to be tough-ish, but we'll see. Well, just got to get over there, essentially. Mm-hmm. And then I have to kill 3 things in melee. 3 things in melee. I know this guy is brutal. He can kill quite a bit, but I don't know if I want to risk him right away. And I got to deal with the Blade Guard veterans, too. I want to kill the wolves in melee. I'll probably use these guys to do it. And then I got to kill 2 more units in melee. This guy can kill, delete a unit based on the rolls. You might want to go that way, though, just to keep him kind of safe, because I want him to, like, stagger around as he plays. I got to keep this guy around here. There's going to be a lot of damage this turn, I think, if things go well. But it's going to be kind of a slow scoring one. Well, we'll see how it goes. So my command phase, I got litanies, or prayers to the dark gods. We got a couple of them to do. He is going to conjure illusory. He's going to do Omen of Potency on himself. He gets it, so he's a little bit physically stronger himself. And then Illusory Supplication probably wants to go on the Possessed beside him. I'm going to see if I get it and then decide where it goes. That's cocked eye. We get it. So I can Illusory Supplicate another target. Love to target the Possessed, but I cannot. It's core character or cultist. So you can target himself, which makes the most sense. Or I could do these guys here, which wouldn't be that bad, because they're going to kind of be out front and up and center too. And he's not going to be in too much of a threatening position. I'm going to target these Legionnaires. They're going to get the Illusory Supplication for now. And we're going to go on to, I think this Demon Engine heals a wound. I just healed a wound there. I believe that is all I care to do in my command phase. I am going to move around some things here. What do these guys want to do? We got to deal with this stuff. It's going to be kind of tough, though, because we got the nasty characters coming up for the counter punch. But Tempting Target, I don't really have to do much. I just have to deal with them, and I can kind of screen with these guys and keep the Possessed here for another turn, maybe. So I'm going to move these guys up, at least, because I know I can kind of, I at least kind of know what I want to do with them, and I can think about that for a little bit. And then I'll chill with them and then see where everything else ends up. They're going to stay there, the Havocs, because they're going to shoot over here to help out. I believe these guys are going to move up to the ruins here, because they are going to try and help out dealing with these Blade Guard veterans as well. In fact, they're going to go right through the ruins now I think about it. They're going to come out that way. We are going to... movement over here is kind of important. After they move, I'm going to come to these cultists. We're going to move them up a little bit here, because I want to just take some little piddly shots over here where I can. To there. These Possessed are going to move up the field this way. Okay, so we're going to move our Possessed up, because I want them to go tango with the Blade Guard veterans. I got to kill a few of the wolves off, actually, just to make that a little bit more doable. So we're going to have you move over there instead. And then you move there, you move here. They have 9-inch movement. They're nuts. Staying an inch away from the wolves, though. Hopefully there's only a couple of left after I throw, like, a grenade or something. These Legionnaires are just moving up back here. And our Dark Apostle moved that way. Then after the Possessed move, the Master of Sanctity, no, the opposite of that, the Master of Possessions moves over to there. And then in the end, I think I'm just going to keep these Possessed here, because I don't really know what I want to do with them. I don't want to commit to two different fights because you can just counteroffensive, and that's not ideal. I'd rather not that be the case. I just need to commit to one of them. So we're going to keep these here as a backup. Oh, you can hero clean intervene. I got a backup three. So these guys, they could go up to six, but if they... Oh, that's tough. I got to keep that in mind, too. Space wolf stuff. I'm probably going to charge in. You know what? Let's go. You move here. I am going to commit the possess a little bit to this move. Ah, I hate it, though. Let's go here with them. Yeah, they're going to chill back here just a little bit further back. I don't like the idea of them being stuck, but this is going to be a threat. And the 6-inch hero convention is kind of scary. Do I just stay out of it? I don't want to commit to this fight whatsoever, so we're going to stay outside of 6 inches of them in every regard, too. So that means this guy's got to back up, too. So I just have to completely change how I move over here. But they're going to move in that position, and then these possessed are going to move to stay outside of their 6 as well. Because the wolves are scary like that, we're going to go on to our reinforcement step, where we're going to have a few of the obliterators show up, a few of them being the squad of 3. I'm not going to do anything fancy with them. They are showing up in my territory, just going to provide some fire support for this objective and that objective. Or they could shoot that direction if I need the help too. They're in a pretty good flexible spot here. They just can't shoot down the middle there. It's going to be, if I shoot at them, it's -1 hit though because of the dense terrain in the way. These Blagard veterans are a little bit more open there. So that's where they're going to end up. We're going to go into the psyche phase. This guy's going to have to carry some pretty heavy weight here. He does get +1 to cast being near this, but I might do the sacrificial dagger. He is going to carve a little bit of his flesh off for Sacrificial Pact with a Sacrificial Dagger, and he'll suffer D3 mortal wounds. Okay, he's going to take 3 mortal wounds. Ooh. But he is a word bearer. He has a 5 up to ignore mortal wounds, so he's going to suffer. Okay, he'll take all 3. Ooh. And then that's going to add 2 to casting, so it'll be a total of +3, and I'm going to cast Cursed Earth here to try and help myself out. I do, so that's a 11 to cast. And then I am going to cast a second power, will be Pact of Flesh. I actually mismoved him a little bit. I'm going to... I got to pay attention to what I'm doing here. I'll commit to it. I will commit to it. I am going to Pact of Flesh. He's going to target himself, which will heal him for D3. He got that, so he's going to heal D3 wounds. Okay, he's back to full. And then his last power is going to be a... That's a good question. Well, he's only really got smite. He'll be smiting. He doesn't roll super well. 9? That's good. All right, D3 mortal wounds to the wolves. I kill 2 of the Fenrisian wolves. I wanted to hit that stupid Terminator with that, but kind of scuffed that one up. It's okay. I don't want to take too many things back. I do need to open the way for to get to those Bladeguard veterans, so it doesn't hurt, also. Not a bad psychic phase. We've got Cursed Earth active, which is very important. It's a bigger aura, too. He's got the Liber Hereticus, so it's a 12-inch aura of Cursed Earth instead of the regular 6. Okay, on to shooting. I'm going to start with these Havocs. They are going to fire into the Thunderwolf Cavalry. And I'll say, you know what? Probably should have moved them. But I didn't want to because I want to put the shots elsewhere if I needed to. Sure, I was also lazy, if I'm to be honest. These two are going to fire at full BS. These two are going to draw... Can't see every part of his base without going through that part there, so they're going to be -1 hit. So that is going to be 2 firing through dense. Didn't matter. And then 2 firing normally. Okay, everything hits anyways. 6s don't matter anymore because we're on turn 2. These are 3s to wound because you're T5. That is 3 wounding hits, and you have shields up. Can they deflect the las cannons?
No!
Would you like to re-roll any of that before you see the damage, or do you want to...
It's D6, right?
D6 per shot. And I have a command point reroll available as well.
I'll reroll one.
Reroll one to try and save a guy. Wow. Okay. All right, that's probably, that's a game, that's a very important roll. So these are 4 wounds each. I need 4 Fs to kill them. The first one will be a dead wolf. Second one won't kill it. And then the third one will. Okay, so it kills 2 of them. 2 of the Thunderwolf get shot down there. Okay, that's not bad. We are going to fire the cultist next and the stubber. So it'll be 9 shots plus a stubber into the Thunderwolf. 9 shots on 4s because they're cultists. And these are going to be 5s to wound. And then before you do any saves, that's one of them. We have the stubber on 5s because it's heavy. Nothing. All right. 2 up save because of the shield. You're okay. Nice. The shield protects this time. Let's go with our Legionnaires next, firing into the Thunderwolf Cavalry. I'm going to chance the plasma gun. I'm going to supercharge it. Even though I probably shouldn't. Here's 3s to hit. Ah, that dummy killed himself. Do I reuse my stupid reroll here? Yeah, everywhere else is... I don't want him to die. Does he still die? Nope, you gotta hit though. Oh, he's got 2 hits, because It's a rapid fire weapon. Look at that, I'm down a command point. Wound on threes. Pair of saves, this is a 4-up invulns because of high AP. Two 4-ups, oh here, second die, you don't need a second die. Invulns, takes 2 damage. 2 wounds left, I got 2, 4, 6. Bolt and the bolt pistol. I've got to do the bolt pistol separate though because you know how it is, guys. Not that phase yet, so it misses. The bolters themselves, everything hits. And these are strength 4. Fives to wound. You have 2 2-up saves. Whoops! Take no damage. Okay. Consider a charge on that one. Who knows? We shall see. That's a unit to kill for blood and guts. I'm going to go on to the Venom Crawler because he doesn't have too many choices. He's going to pump his shots right into the blood claws he's fighting. They're under assault as well, so they're not even negative 1. This thing's pretty good. 6 shots with those excruciator cannons. They are not blasts either. So these are 3s to hit. 6s are good. There are no 6s though. And because assault weapons are good now. Not melee yet though. 3s to wound. 2 of them at AP 2. Terminator should have 3-up saves here. He does take 2 damage and dies though. Pop, 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 pop. Excruciator guns. And okay. Our master of possessions is gonna fire his, he's gonna throw a crack grenade at the Fenrisian wolves. Let's wanna kill one more wolf essentially. That's a very cocked die. That is a miss. All right, he tried his damn best. Okay, oh, the rest of this is very, not difficult, but difficult. I am gonna do that Marine. This sergeant is going to throw a crack grenade at the wolves, and the rest of these guys are going to fire into the Blade Guard veterans. We're going to do the melt a gun first. It hits, and it wounds, and you have a shield. Invulnerable, nice, right off the shield. Excellent. And then we got the crack grenade, which hits. Grenades probably don't care right now, and it's, I don't know what kind of save they have. This is AP1. I'll roll a d6, and we'll see. If you roll a 6, I'll look it up. That's a, he hasn't dropped die. You reroll if you want. Okay, no, I killed the one wolf. There's one wolf left. Cyber wolf, actually. The 3 remaining guys have bolter rounds. Well, you know what? I'll count that as a 1. It's super flat. But the 6 counts as another hit. So 5 hits, 4s to wound the blade guard. That's 3 saves on the blade guard at 2 up. 2s! No damage. And then the possessed don't have guns. I have this squad back here to fire. I will fire everything to the Blade Guard veterans, except the melt gun, if it doesn't have range. I will not fire that. Yeah, not gonna shoot that. So I will fire, where the bolt pistol is within 12, and the 3 bolt guns as well. So the bolt pistol, use this bad boy. Bolt pistol, hits, and the 6 bolters. I wish these guys had chain swords, but whatever. I'll make use of the bolters now if I can. And then that's all the hits. I'll throw in 1 more for the bolt pistol, and that's 3 saves. At 2s. No damage. Should wrap up my little shooting. I am gonna resolve my obliterators now, firing to the Blade Guard veterans. I think the best option is the middle one here for ruinous salvo. It's D3 plus 3 shots per gun, per obliterator, and the strength 7 minus 2, 2 damage. Because you have a 4-up invuln, so this brings you right to the 4-up. So might as well go with that. It's gonna be 9 shots plus 3D3. So, okay, an extra 6 shots. So it'll be 15, as opposed to the 6 that would have been. 15 shots on 3s. Got a few misses in there. And these are all heavy, so don't need to worry about 6s. These are 3s to wound. And no rerolls here, no. And that many saves. Every 2 fails is a dead Blade Guard. So I kill 1.5.
2 wounds?
Yeah, I have 1 wound left on him. So we got 4 remaining, though 1 is heavily wounded. That will conclude my shooting. We're gonna go on to some charges. I'm gonna start with the simple ones. The Dark Apostle here is gonna declare a charge against the Blood Claws. Oop, that's good enough. He'll end up right there. And then we are going to have our Possessed declare a charge against the Blade Guard veterans. Let's see what they get. A 5, ooh, that's iffy. A little bit of a gamble. I have to use a command point reroll. They need a 6 on the dice. Damn! Ooh. Damn, a double 5. That really scuffs the, that. You know what? That's probably for the best overall. Because that, if my entire plan worked out perfectly, I would have been in a great position. But now I have to, oh, I got to throw away the Legionnaires now. That's going to scuff up that. I can't believe they failed that double. Oh, man. God damn it. Well, that puts me in a conundrum. They're going to stand there like the dummies they are and think about what they've done. And then these guys, because they're within 3 inches of the Blade Guard veterans, it forces my hand to have to charge. I was kind of hoping these guys would go in, but I kind of went with extreme confidence. It's one of those, a 6-inch reusable charge is impossible to fail until it isn't, if you know what I mean. This example right here, where I'm now very sad, but it's okay. We will overcome this great struggle. I am gonna continue charging. These guys have to roll pretty high on their charge for me to accomplish what I want to do here. We're gonna declare a charge against the Fenrisian Wolf. A five. Okay, that is... Boys, that's not what I said. That's a hot charge. Needed them to go. They
up and over.
Yeah. Spoiler. I need more than that five. Yeah. I needed them to get up and over there, get within an inch of him, and then chain to the objective.
Right.
So this is gonna put me at a deficit for points pretty heavily. And I blundered earlier too. I actually kind of forgot that they were behind the ruin there. So when I was like, I don't need to put a Lucifer's Supplication on him. I gotta put it on some unit that's nearby. So I'll put it on them because they're gonna charge forward and block. But I didn't realize they were there. I should have definitely put it on them. I'm not gonna take it back, but I 100% should have put a Lucifer's Supplication on them because of their final position. Mm-hmm. It might not have mattered whatsoever, but I mean, we'll see when it comes up. Okay, I have a couple more charges to do. I am gonna risk this one all the same. And they're gonna go eight. Okay, well, thank you for rolling. Oh, that could help me out here, actually. I can use that to go pretty far up there and then pile it, or consolidate if I beat this guy. Okay, so we are gonna move them in. Well, they do make it in,
really?
And if I could pop this guy, I could consolidate onto the objective, which will help me out immensely. Okay, not bad, not bad. The last charge I have to do is, I think I'm done, actually. I don't think I have any other charges.
You're not gonna charge the Blade Guard?
Oh yes, you're right. Thank you again. I couldn't see them on that side of the friggin' ruin. I'm like, how did I immediately forget? Charge, Blade Guard. Let's go. Seven. Nice. It works.
There you go.
Because if I don't charge, I don't get my Zealot reroll. Because they're just gonna pile into me.
Too far separated now, or?
Oh yeah, I'll have to fix that. One correction: I will declare the Wolf as the charge target as well because I need to kill him. I need to kill three things in melee. So the goal is Blood Claws, Wolf, and like. Let's be real, it's not going to be them. I'll be that guy over there. Okay, that should be it for my charge. Just have to fix this guy's position. Sorry, he'll be over here. Move my guy around, just hitting all the terrain in general. Where I fight first is kind of important as well. I'm pretty safe over here, because you can't interrupt. I'm going to fight with the guys in the middle. I get full rerolls, because I am Word Bearers, and I am going to attack the Blade Guard veterans. What I'm going to do is... put two of the Legionnaires, the guy in base contact with the Wolf and the one right beside him, into the Cyber Wolf. Hopefully we kill it. It is a Cyber Wolf. It's technically a little bit more durable. It's got a feel no pain. And then the Champion and his two honored friends into the Blade Guard veterans. There's a wound on the unit, so I'm going to do the Legionnaires first without the Power Fist. So the two into the Cyber Wolf, it'll be six attacks. Three is to hit a Cyber Wolf, but I get full rerolls, and sixes don't matter here because I'm not quite on the third turn. One miss. Four is to hurt it. That's not promising. I have no AP. I believe he's got a 5 or 6 up save. And that's going to be a 2. But you do have a feel no pain, I think, on the Cyber Wolf. He's got one wound. No feel no pain, but two wounds. Not the feel no pain I'm thinking of. They have a 4 up armor save. And they have two wounds. There's one wound left on the Cyber Wolf. All right, so plan has failed. This has been... It was... The turn went, like, so good, dude. It was, like, the perfect turn. All of a sudden, boom, drop dead. That's the beauty of the game, though. Okay, let's try the 6 attacks into the Blade Guard veterans now. All of this. And one more. Reroll. The 2. Okay, still misses. These are going to be forced to wound Blade Guard. One save at a 2 up on the Blade Guard. Shields up. You're A-okay. And then the Champion with his Power Fist get to go here. Hitting on 4s before rerolls. Ah, dang it. Okay, 2 hits, 2s to wound, and shields. 2 saves. Yep, 2 4 ups. I kill one and wound another. Suppose I'll take it. That's 4 less attacks my way, but I think you're still gonna cleave through these Legionnaires with ease, sadly for me. All right, one wound left. And then that's my charge done there. And then Rob is looking to interrupt here with counteroffensive and have this Thunderwolf pack leader attack with his Thunder Hammer into the Legionnaires before it is time. He'll get an extra attack because I charged him and he hits on 3s, but you got 3 hits there, and these are 2s to wound Legionnaires. Okay. Only 2 of them. These are only AP 2 currently, so I'll have 5 ups. I'll make neither. That guy gets crushed, and this guy's gonna get crushed. And then we have a Thunderwolf on 2s. A couple of hit, all 3 hit, because he gets +1 to hit, and these are 3s to wound. 2 more wounds. 5 ups, I believe. Oh, that's gonna be enough to kill another guy. Alright, well, just the Plasma Gun and the Power Fist left. And then I'm gonna just go ahead and attack over here. Might as well get it out of the way. Okay, let's do the Legionnaire, the Champion, see if he just gets this done and over with. 4s to hit with a reroll. Word Bearers. Ooh, they all hit. 3s to wound, though, your T5. I almost have to reroll one of these, but I'm going to save the command point. So 4 up save. Invulnerable! You can command point with your last command point to keep him alive. But you'll get one on your turn, but you'll be down to the one. We're going to command point reroll. Oh, he gets crushed by the Power Fist. Okay. So he does go down. And then we are going to... That's 1 point for Blood and Guts. I'll take that at least. At least that worked out. And then they can consolidate, which I will do just because... well, I guess we'll stay like kind of right here. Consolidate there just to block the bridge. The bridge is the blood, dude. There's going to be a lot of bodies on these bridges. And okay, last thing I have to do is my Dark Apostle. Dark Apostle's up next here. He's going to try and crush some of these blood claws. Let's figure out how many attacks he gets. He's got 9 attacks. He's 5 base. Omen of Potency is active for 3 more, and he's got an Exalted. Well, he's actually got 6 base because of the Exalted Possession, and 3 more for Omen of Potency. Now he's got the 8 Fold Cursed Crozius, which is a Word Bearer Crozius, so if I hit the enemy, I wound the enemy, unless they have the monster or vehicle keyword. So, 2's to hit. I wound you 9 times. Those are AP4, so no save. He killed 9, he'd killed 9 Blood Claws.
Damn.
Boom, boom, boom. Yeah, he's a clapper. And we're gonna consolidate towards the nearest enemy, which is that wolf there. I don't know if I want to consolidate, but I will. What does he got? He pushes leadership ores further forward. Just kind of hangs out over here in general, I guess. That's another tally for Blood and Guts. He takes some of the name of the Dark Gods. Does he want to chill there? Kind of. We're never going to get our raised banners. All right, that's it for my attacks. He doesn't get to fight. You get to fight with your Bladeguard veterans. Please do not carve up my guys. Okay, we got 4 attacks each. It'll be 13 attacks because of the Pact Leader into my Legionnaires. With no illusory supplication. These are 2 to hit because the wolves. Okay, you know what? I don't care about the illusory supplication because you rolled really well anyways. It would have been 4 misses, but everything hits instead. You guys, I would not survive after those initial hits. These are 3s to wound. So even if I took away 4 of the wounds in there, 4. All right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'd still have 7 saves. I have 6 saves, which is still enough to kill them. So I'll do the first 6, you know. So that's 4 dead. Okay, they're... Oh, I would have... No, I would have all. I only had 5 guys. Okay, so illusory supplication did not matter. So I guess, you know what? It is in a useful spot. I only blundered by failing the charge, which is out of my control. Consolidating and pushing the line forward. Okay, that is it for my turn. I do believe I owe you a morale check over. I can't remember if they're leadership 9 or 8 still, but I'm going to roll a 4, which is a 7. They're okay. I only lost 3 homies. That is the end of my turn. Scoring, unfortunately, don't get a whole lot, but I do take one of these objectives away. Which doesn't matter because you're still going to get max points on your turn. So I am just like in a bad spot. But we're going on to turn 3, which means you're probably going to go to the Assault Doctrine, I assume.
Assault Doctrine it is.
And I'm in the last part of Let the Galaxy Burn. So pistols, assault, and melee weapons will trigger extra hits. So we both have the same rule. 6 to hit will be additional hits in that regard. Being greased by attempting target. I'm going to keep attempting target because I can probably get it on my next turn. I'm going to get rid of raised banners though. There's way too much combat and bloodshed going on. And I would like to draw another one. And if I can kill a unit in melee, I'll get Blood and Guts on Rob's turn. So I just got to kill one unit in melee. So that should work out. Here we currently are. Rob is going to score 15 points for primary because he's on 3 of the objectives. I'm only on 2 of them right now. Oh boy, this is bad for me. The Space Wolves are getting near max points on this turn. Battlefield Supremacy is automatically scored as long as Rob does nothing. And Raised Banners is automatically scored as long as, you know, they do nothing. And then no prisoners you have to work towards. So hold 3 objectives and more than me, perform the Raised Banner action on an objective in No Man's Land, and then kill 30 wounds worth of my models throughout any amount of turns. So Battlefield Supremacy, you're on 1 of the objectives, 2 of the objectives, 3 of the objectives. So that's already done. Raise banners, it'll be... I guess you could raise banners with the unit back here if you really wanted to charge in with them. So you have the option either way. You just have to perform the action on 1 of the 2 No Man's Lands. You can even do this one over here. Well, I'm on this one. You can't do this one. You have to kill them first, then do it. But a little bit easier on those two. And then just kill my things, which is kind of ideal as well. So all of those are options to you. But we have litanies to chant over here. Let's see. What is inspiring? And what are we thinking for the first prayer?
Canticle of Hate.
Boop, 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 boop. 6, we're good. Do the reroll aura as well.
Exhortation of Rage. Miss.
Wise aura. He doesn't have Wise Orator. Okay, yeah.
Right.
This is the bonus to charge and bonus to consolidation aura active, or thing active-ish. Mm-hmm. Then we're right on to moving, so zip up, move over here, and then Murderfang advances a 4, coming up and around the building. Just more waves of things I got to deal with, honestly. And that's it for moving here. And then we have our Blood Claws moving forward. Are they going to raise banners?
Yeah, they're going to raise banner. I'm going to put that in there.
All right. This part of the battlefield, those Blade Guard veterans are going to keep pushing up the field. They're just an unstoppable Wolf Guard force. I love Space Wolf Blade Guards. Feel so good. Wolf Guard battle leader keeps pushing up the middle, and I assume the Blood Claws are going to follow as well. Just got to push across the bridge. It's about taking ground here. Excellent board for this mission, too. And the two Dreadnoughts following up. We're going to advance the Fenrir Wolves because their job is done.
That's
a six. So they're going real fast up and around the northern bridge, or the furthest bridge from at me as I record. From there, they zip up and around. They're coming across the bridge, ready to put pressure on that objective later as the Blood Claws are going to eventually push forward. We're on to the shooting phase. Okay. Yeah, they're going to raise banners at the end of the movement phase, which will complete at the end of the turn. Bjorn is going to fire his Hellfrost into the Possessed.
Possessed, yes.
All right, with the focus, D3 shots or the one
focus
shot?
Focus being the one shot.
One shot, that is a hit. Strength probably pretty good. Enough to wound on a 3 or a 2 even.
We'll That's check.
Good enough. Burn right through their armor. Luckily, they're standing on some cursed earth, so... This D3 plus 3, I only have 3 wounds. I'm going to humbly accept that that possessed is annihilated by the gun. How much damage?
Oh, it would have been 4.
Yeah. Good enough to kill him. Okay. One Neo Volkite and 2 heavy bolt pistols forward.
So I'll do the heavy bolt pistol first. Ooh, as that splits.
Was a hit, there's a 6, and a wound with the bolt pistol. And throw the Neo Volkite while we're standing here. Couple shots, couple hits, and.
Strength 5.
Couple of wounds as well. So only one wound on the Neo Volkite, the RT5. So I'll save the Neo Volkite first. I pass, and then the bolt pistol, I fail. 1 damage. And the battle leader's Neo Volkite behind them, couple hits, and 4 to wound. 6 is their ideal. 1 wound. Still, though, pretty good if I fail.
Potato.
Yeah. Yeah, there you go. I am going to not reroll that. I'm going to keep my command point because I think I could use it. I'm just going to take the hit on this guy, sadly. 2 damage on the Neo Volkite. Okay, well, that was pretty good for little piddly shots. The Blood Claws in the back, we're going to unholster the pistols and fire. We got a plasma pistol, who I assume wants to supercharge.
Yeah, I'll supercharge.
Starting with him first, only 3. Don't roll the 1. You're good. Ooh. That's a hit. Ooh, no. 3 to wound.
Ooh.
That's a wound. I have my demon save, which we fail. That's 2 damage. It's going to be 2 damage on that guy. That's not ideal. I'm going to put it on, I guess, the guy in the... It doesn't really matter at this point. It's getting a little bad. Uh-oh! And that's all hit. And these are 5s to wound. They have AP as well. 1 wound.
AP minus 2.
We're good. And the Stormbolter from the Wolf and Dread. We have 2 hits. And 5s to wound. Please don't hurt me. Oh, no, stop.
Come on.
And hook. Gonna take it.
That's
2 left.
That's done from that corner then.
That's pretty good. They can't shoot, and then there's a little bit of shooting over there. We have a crack grenade and this guy's bolt rifles. What would you like to do first?
No, we'll do bolt rifles first.
Bolt rifles. 3s to hit, all hit. My dice are betraying me. I see so many taco cats. Oh god, 3 wounds. P1, so 4s. Oh, I do take a wound. Throw a crack grenade if you want.
Crack.
Crack hits, he's a lord. And wounds. 4 up on the power armor. Oh, we're good. Power armor deflects it. No problem.
And he's got storm bolter, heavy bolt, and heavy flamer.
He did advance, though.
Oh, duh. Sorry.
We'll start with some charges over here, because shooting is now finished. Where do you want to start?
Wolf Lord.
Wolf Lord? He is in. He's in, and then the chaplain. Priest is in as well. Oh, boy. And from there, we come to some charges over here. Blade Guardian will clear a charge against Possessed and my Master of Possession, sadly. They're going to roll a 5. Yes, they are in it to win it. Luckily, there's 1 wounded there, and Cursor should be able to take him out. Help me out a little bit with that. Yeah, they're staying away from the Dark Apostle over there. See if the Cursor takes him. Oh, it's D3 mortal wounds. That's a 5. 2. It just kills one and wounds another. We're going to wound that guy down to 2. And then, who's next? Who's next for the mortal wounds?
The wolf.
The wolf, yeah. This is actually really smart charging the wolf in. That means I can't hero convene and kill him, or get a kill on him in melee. So he'll charge 7, and then he's just gonna die. He charges and then dies. Battle leader behind will charge in. A 4 and a 6?
6.
That should be good. I wish I got the 6 earlier. Oh. All right, he'll charge in, and does the cursed earth hit him? No, that's cocked eye. Does it hit him? Once. 1 mortal wound on him. Should have 4 left. We'll double check that later. 4 left on him. Who's next? Blood Claws?
Yep. They're going 8-inch charge.
That is an 8. Nice. Gonna charge in. Charging outside of the Dark Apostles here at convention range. They can pile in attack later. 2 up. They take, 1 mortal wound on the unit. 1 remaining wound on that Blood Claw. That should be it for charging.
I'm going to start with the Blood Claws into them.
Yes, sir. Here comes the Terminator. And then the rest of it is going to form a line behind. You might as well go with the Terminator first, because they're 3 wounds each, and each one that succeeds will clap a possessed. And the Wolfguard Battle Leader, Shock Assault. Oh, that is going to be 2 extra hits with the Thunderhammer. It'll be 3s to wound. Oh, one more. I'll just reroll that one then, because there'd be an extra 4th wound in there, maybe. Yeah, 4 saves. They're minus 3 because of the Assault Doctrine. So these are 4 pinballs. Oh, he kills them all.
Hey, Bloodclaw.
Oof. Okay, that's... That's they were dead anyways, it's okay. That's more wounds for no prisoners. Could interrupt. They could consolidate too, if they wanted to, but that means you'd be getting in range of that guy. I don't know if you want to.
They'll pile in.
Boop, boop, boop. They're coming in and they're gonna try and put down. If I can keep this Master Possession alive, I'm A-okay. 9 attacks from the 2 of them on 2s. A couple misses, keep that 1 in there because he got the 6. He's to wound the Master of Possessions. He needs to live. Oh, that's not bad.
So bad.
That's 4 of them, eh? He's got Cursed Earth active, so hopefully that'll keep him alive for the most part. He's 2 at a time, 4 Binvolns. He takes 2. He's okay. He's okay. He only takes 2 damage. He's got 3 wounds left. Big. No, the downside is I can't fall back with him because he's got 3 psychic powers. I'm not going to lose 3 psychic powers. He'd rather go down in a blaze of glory than back up and not cast them. And then that's it. Now the Wolf Guard, the Battle Leader could pile him, but he can't attack anything because the target he charged is dead.
That's right.
Then we're gonna go over to here. What do you want to attack with first? I was gonna pull him, you never know, Stranger Things, I guess.
Thunderhammer.
Thunderhammer or Lord, he should have 5 attacks on the charge. What is his Warlord traits?
Saga of the Warrior Born and Hunter.
Always fights first and advance and charge. Okay, so it was 5 attacks on the charge. We got a couple misses, but 1 extra hit because of the 6. 2s to wound. 4 saves at -3, so these are 6 ups. Yeah, okay, there we go, dead. Bloop. And then they do get to consolidate further because of the Canticle of Hate. Petrus Wolf Lord is going to break right through, whereas the Wolf Priest is going to pile in and consolidate like a little bit. He wants to stay within 3 of the objective, though. Okay, well, that was rough. I get to attack back with the Master of Possessions. 5 attacks with his Nerd Stick. We reroll because we are Word Bearers. And that's 2 more hits with the Nerd Stick. 3s to wound. That's not bad. That's 4 saves at 3 up. And, ooh, failed 2. These are D3 damage each. There's a guy with 2 wounds, so he's dead. There we go. Got him. Leaves me with 1 Blade Guard to deal with there. This is going to be a horribly bloody game. We are going to absolutely just destroy each other. Okay. All right. And that is going to be it. So you do score quite a bit of points, though, because you finish raising the Space Wolf banner for the route, and then you are... I'm trying to think of the word to connect it. You are Battlefield Supremacy. Currently succeeding at Battlefield Supremacy, holding a majority of the objectives on the table. However, not quite finishing No Prisoners, but doing a damn good job of it. So you killed 2 Legionnaires and 5 Possessed. That's 15, 19 wounds out of the 30 done immediately. Right, on to turn 3. It's looking bad for the Word Bearers, but there is still a lot of game to play here. I get 5 more points for primary because I'm only on the 1 objective. I am being absolutely bullied back here. And then I'm at 5 for secondaries here because I've been a little too greedy with my secondaries. And then, so I'm at 15 points to Rob's 45 is what I'm saying. Let's do some litanies on Mr. Scary over there, our Dark Apostle. So we are going to opt to do... Illusory Supplication on, that's a tough call. I think I want to do it on himself because these obliterators are not core, so I can't hit them with it. He's going to make a clone of himself. He does. And then he's going to go for Omen of Potency. He does. The command phase. I technically score my 5 points for holding this objective over here now. And, my cards. So I still have Blood and Guts from last turn. I have to kill 1 unit to succeed. That should be doable. The wolf, unfortunately, threw its life away and denied me the point on the previous turn, so that was bad. Secure No Man's Land. That is control 2 in No Man's Land. I'm going to try and do that. And then, did I get rid of Tempting Target? I did. Okay. Investigate Site is the new one. I'm going to spend a command point. I'll go down to 3 and get rid of that. Grind them down. So I have to kill more of Rob's units this turn than he kills on his 4th turn, and then I'll succeed. So these Legionnaires are going to move towards the Blood Claws, as well as the Venom Crawler. Pushing up that way. I gotta keep the Venom Crawler within 9 of this guy, though. Well, I don't have to, but I would like to. He's gonna stay in combat. These obliterators are gonna move forward. Back the Havocs up so they don't get so easily tagged at the edge, then they're gonna take some shots at that Wolf Priest on the bridge. Keep the Champion there, and then we're gonna We're going to commit these possessed to a fight. I'm going to try and take out this lord here. That should conclude it. We are going to go on to our psychic phase. We're going to start with a pact of flesh on himself because nothing else is really hurt. Okay, I would have loved that for Smite. Hmm. He's going to heal D3 wounds. It's back up to full. And then he is going to smite. 1 and 6, which is 8. So D3 mortal wounds to that blade guard. Oh, he's got 2 wounds left, eh? And then he'll throw down a cursed earth. Got it. That was easy. And then we're going to go on a shooting. I'm just going to use my bolt pistol while I'm in combat. Shoot that guy. Hit. Nope. Got to move him. I was just going to move him to here. He was just going to fight the guys in the middle, essentially. Or maybe the pack leader. Who knows? Who knows? Okay. Shooting now. Let's go ahead and do... That's a tough call. Let's do a crack grenade from him into that squad there. He hits. Is that a 5? That's a 5? That does wound? Yeah, they got the blood claw with the wound on him. 4 up! He's dead. Take that blood claw. One less to worry about. We are going to have our venom crawler fire into the blood claws here. Not worrying about the -1 to hit because we're all close enough to it. 3's to hit. These are assaults, so that does count as an extra hit. And then 3's to wound. You are going to have 2 saves. The Terminator takes him, he's got 3 ups. Otherwise, the other guys have 4 ups. Or 5 ups, actually.
How many damage?
2 each. Mm. So he could kind of eat him a little bit.
Yeah, let's go on Terminator.
3's! He's A-okay. So note the Venom Crawler does go to 6 wounds from 5, because he heals 1 in my turn. We are going to have these Legionnaires fire everything into the Blood Claws ahead of us. I will do the Melta Gun first. Yeah, no rerolls there. The champion will throw a crack grenade, which will be a hit. No wound. And then bolt guns. Okay, we got just 3 hits. They gotta go back to Marine school, dude. 2 wounds. 2 up saves on the Terminator. He's okay. They're done. We're gonna go ahead with the Havocs. We're gonna have this guy fire into the Blood Claws, the champion. Then the 4 Lascans are gonna go into the Wolf Priest in the back. Lascans, do me some good here. They all hit. 3's to wound. Couple of fails, eh? Hmm. Reroll one of those. It does not wound. 2 invulnerable saves. It's only D6 damage. You will live. I don't know if you want to reroll or not.
No.
D6 damage. It's 3. 4 wounds remaining, and then the cultists are gonna fire into him as well. It'll be a stubber and 9 auto guns. The stubber has a hit, which does it wound? Nope. And the auto guns, quite a bit hits. And 1 more for that 5. 1 wound. 1 power armor save. He's okay. Then I did forget to do the champion. He's gonna fire his bolt gun. Over that way, it's only a single shot. Hit. Nope. And we're onto the flesh metal weapons over here. These are all gonna go into, well, kind of the Wolf and Dreadnought because we have to. Yeah. Gonna be Focus Malice. D3 shots per guy, so it's the actual average, 6 shots. Our 3's to hit. Ah, womp womp, that's okay. Game hard. Let's see if we wound on 3's. No, we got 1 wound at least. And then you have a 4 up invuln. And you make it on a 6. 0 damage from the obliterators. I knew I didn't want to bring 3, you guys. You're a liability. All right, that is it for shooting. Not great overall, but we're going to charge now. We're going to charge the obliterators into the character and the Blade Guard veteran and the Blood Claws, because they're going to pile in anyways.
All 3 units?
Yeah, we did all 3 there. We're going to hope for the best on them. We're going to charge the Dark Apostle in, both targets. He'll make it. Right there. Hello and hello. Then gonna charge in the Legionnaires to these guys. They're going to make it, barely. I'm gonna have you just go to there, and you're just gonna chill here. Can't quite go over that, but this'll work, I guess. The Venom Crawler will charge them as well. You go 5, good enough. Just get within an inch. And I do have a couple more charges, or 1 more charge, right here. They are gonna go into the Wolf Lord. They are gonna make it. Oh, but he can hear clearly mean 6, eh? That, mm-hmm. that means I can attack him though. Interesting.
Yes.
The pack work together. There's no way I can stop it. So if he hero intervenes, we'll have a bunch of guys over here. Charge, so hero intervenes. It's cost a command point to do 6, but it's free for them. He didn't really need to, so. We have 3 critical fights across the board here. Relatively safe on a few fronts. This guy's probably gonna survive. I think I'm safest to go with those the possessed on that front. We have the Armor of Rust over here to pick. We're going to go with the Obliterators, so they are just going to fight normally, as if they've already been in a prolonged combat. They do not get to fight until all your stuff's already fought, but I charge with them, so they just counteract each other. So I'm going to go with these guys first. Part of me wants to do Revered Host to try and get as much damage in as possible over here. But that means I'll have no command points anywhere else, because I was a dummy and used a reroll earlier, even though I knew I shouldn't have. I can take out both these characters. That's a lot of pressure alleviated from this side, and I think I need Revered Host to do just that. So I'm going to spend two command points on Revered Host. They get to reroll all wound rolls. Would you like to save my command points for defensive moves? But not in this case. So I'm going to put two of them into the Chaplain, three into the Lord. Those two, it'll be 10 attacks. The champion's in the middle there. Mm-hmm. These are twos to hit the Chaplain. Rerolling because we're Ward Bearers. And then we have an extra three hits because of the sixes. You're going to wound on fours, but this is why we used Revered Host, because look at this roll. The first roll is nice. Oh, that's not a wound. So we have four wounds, and then these all get to reroll. And it's going to be five more wounds. That's nine saves on him at Invulns. Invulns, it takes six damage. It's two each.
Yep.
The Chaplain does go down, and then we put the 16 attacks into the Wolf Lord. And the attacks into the Lord on twos, rerolling the ones. I could reroll everything, I guess, to fish for more sixes, which I usually like to do when I'm hitting on twos. But we'll take that. And we got three extra hits. Forced wound with the reroll because of the Revered Host for the Ward Bearers. And the reroll. A few more, four more, actually. So it's nine saves on him as well, two damage each. Nine four-ups. Oh, that's an amazing roll. Excellent. Well done. It's only four damage. He lived. Damn. He had to fail two more to survive that. You might as well attack with him next. I know it's a little out of order. Do you want to... Sorry. Okay, before we do that, do you want a counteroffensive anywhere before I go with my other charges?
Because who's left?
I guess we can just go back to the Lord and do it later. I have to fight with all of this still. No counteroffensive, so I'm just going to go ahead and keep fighting. Let's go with our... let's go with our Legionnaires fighting... into the blood claws here. Piling in up and over, we'll start with the regular Legionnaire attacks. I'll start with the regular Legionnaires. Threes to hit with the reroll, and sixes are good, because we're also Space Wolves. I just play the Chaos version of Space Wolves currently. Forced wound, not much, four, five. All two up, you can do three at a time for two ups, in case you roll somehow, like a bunch of twos. He's okay, and then the rest are two ups. All right, and then we're gonna do the Demonic Blade, I guess. Demon Blade twos. I definitely want to see the sixes here. This is essentially Neo Volkite and melee. It's got AP though, I guess. These are, I think, strength five. Well, definitely four wounds. Do two at a time on the Terminator because it's two damage each. He's got three ups. He takes two damage, and then we got one at a time now. He is alive. He is dead. Terminator succumbs to the Demon Blade, and then unfortunately. That does mean I cannot fight with my stupid Venom Crawler because of the wall. Minus the defense line. We're good to go. Don't have to pile in. Extra reach with the defense line. Threes to hit with a reroll. These were Ward Bearers. They all hit plus one. And... ha! Two wounds. Look at that. Six ups! I killed two. Four claws. Bloop and a bloop. Excuse me as I cheat, I meant to consolidate with him after they killed that Terminator. I'm like, I need to get more models onto the objective. Because you pull from the back, it doesn't change how they get pulled. They would go there, and you would end up here. Just getting more models on there. You try and help me out. Though it's not going to help me out this turn, it'll help me out in the future. In fact, it doesn't help me out at all, really. Okay, that's it for my charge. I get the Dark Apostle who can go, ooh. Well, he's going to just put... I kind of want to take out that Wolf Guard battle leader. Because I got to kill units. It's important to kill units completely. Because I don't know how to split the numbers for the math on this one, because of the invulnerable slaves, I'm going to put all the attacks in the blood claws. Because I still get to fight with the obliterators, just not right now. The eightfold curse Crozius. Twos to wound. Reroll. Now, the funny thing here is the sixes give me extra hits. I have to actually roll the wound with those. These are, I think... No, those don't do anything. These rank seven, not eight. Nine saves on them that are three damage each. So the first fail will kill the Terminator. Four up invulns, one at a time though. Boop. All right, unless you want to reroll, he's dead. Then the rest all die as well, because they're all AP4. The reroll to keep him alive. Okay, he tanks one of them. The next one, he dies. Okay.
Damn.
And then the other seven wounds will kill they're all AP4, so no save at all.
No.
He invokes no interaction, no rolls allowed, only dead models. Look at that chaplain go. You can't stop the word bearer Dark Apostle. All right. Okay, so I have no other charges to go. You get to do a non-charge elect now. And then I still do get to fight with the nerd, them, and that's it, actually. We're gonna go with the battle leader and the obliterators, mostly because of Illusory Supplication and the ablative wounds on the Dark Apostle. Twos to hit. They all hit. Nice. Strength five?
Strength five.
Fours to wound. Okay, that is a wound. One save, we are gonna make it because we have Cursed Earth active on us. And then I get to do my non, I'll go with the obliterators. I could go with the psyker, but I'm just gonna go with the obliterators. I'll do one into the battle, what's it called?
Blade guard,
thank you, pack leader. And then these guys are gonna attack the wolf guard battle leader. The obliterator trying to punch him with his crushing fists, I believe they're called. Reroll that. And then that's an extra hit there for the five. These are twos to wound. Four saves at your invuln. Giving you the hands. That is six damage. And Pete grabs him from behind and kind of rips him in half. Ooh. And then we have the eight attacks in the battle leader. Him on threes. Ooh boy, with some rerolls. That's a miss. We have two sixes in there, which will give us two more hits, which wound on twos. And that is going to be six, four up invulns on him as well. Okay. Fours. Oh, that's still four damage. Does just die. All right, so we clear out quite a bit of the middle.
That's three units for you, I think, too.
That is, yeah, I killed one, two, three units there, and four with the chaplain. Because that'll give me four unit kills for blood, grind them down. And if Rob's able to kill four of my units back, to stop it, I lose the game, effectively. They get to fight, though. They absolutely get to fight my guys. That guy gets to fight, so I am gonna consolidate with these guys a little bit just to protect the Dark Apostle. You know what? I guess I'm gonna... No, we're gonna stay where we are. Screw it. I want him to kind of be a little bit more open-ish. However, this guy's gonna consolidate to protect the stupid Psyker. So we'll go like that. We'll do that. All right, these guys are gonna pile in and strike at my Legionnaires. If I can hold with a few of them, I will hold the objective, because I'll have just, we'll see. We'll hope for the best. Might as well do the power fist first. This should be three attacks, because of shock assault, because it's two base. And threes, because you're a space wolf. That is going to be three hits, because of the six. Twos to wound. And that's two of them. These are six ups. I make neither. All right, well, you're dead. You're dead. That's a couple more wounds for no prisoners and lots of chainswords. Oh, that's a great roll for chainswords. That's three extra hits. That's nine hits from the chainswords that are wounding on fours at AP two. This will probably get me pretty good. Great roll. That's five. I want chainswords, dude. Come on. That's two more dead. All right, that's you and you dead. So that does secure the objective in your favor. We both have obsec on it, but you have three models to my two. Big point swing again in the Space Wolves' favor. I'm going to have to clean up. I'm doing well. I'm cleaning up quite a bit here.
Yes, you are.
That's another four. There are 27 for no prisoners. If you can kill one of these guys, you'll get no prisoners before you draw cards, which is ideal. So he's got that Thunderhammer. He's got five attacks because I charge you. Whoa. And they're threes to hit. Six are good. That's nope. One. That's two misses, but four hits because of the six. And these are going to wound on threes against my possessed. Okay, there's two of them there. I need to fail one of these saves. The minus three, so I go to my demon save. I make neither. You crush two of them dead. That will be no prisoners. You'll die and you'll die, leaving the champion and two possessed. That will be the end of the turn. The only place I might have to do a morale check is on that one legionnaire there, but he's within 9 inches of my Dark Apostle, which makes him leadership 11. So he does not run. He is as brave as a custodian. That is gonna be it. Now for secondaries, I do put my blood and guts to 3 out of 3, so I finished that this turn, and I killed 4 units for grinding them down, so I'll finish at the end of Rob's turn if he doesn't kill 4 units. Then secure no man's land. I just don't even think that's gonna happen. Like, I'm on none of the middle. I cannot catch a break on objectives. I am just falling short by a little bit here and there. And on my turn 4, it's just probably not gonna happen. I don't know. I'm gonna get rid of it. Oh, God, such an easy one to do. Why am I getting rid of such an easy objective? I don't understand. What is happening? Why is it so hard to get these? Don't see myself getting secure no man's land. I can get one of them.
Right.
There's just too many bodies. Like, here comes another wave of guys up the middle.
Right.
They're just throwing their lives away, buying time, securing these bridges for reinforcements to show up, and it's working. All right, turn 4 for the wolves now. throwing up the current score, Rob is going to jump up to 40 points on primary because he's on all the objectives except for mine again, just keeping me in my deployment zone. 1, 2, 3 of the objectives, sticky for the Marines, and then the territory one to my one. So that's an easy 15 points there. Is that scored 5 secondaries to my 2. So it's just, I don't think I can come back from this, but the turn's going to be quick enough that I think we can see. So I'm going to start scoring a lot more on my turn 4 and 5 is the thing. So I'd see what I can get here.
However, Rob just drew 3 more amazing well, granted, downs, whatever, but tempting target, automatically done. Defense stronghold, automatically done. I cannot challenge either one of them.
For tempting target, I'm going to say you have to, I have to pick one of these 3 objectives that you already all control, so I'll say you have to control that one at the end of this turn. Grind them down is going to be difficult, but defense stronghold is, as long as you control your objective at the end of my next turn, you get it. So that's another 2 points chalked up for you easily, just by existing. So you just gotta keep me tied down where I am to a degree and hope for the best, because you have a massive point lead and you can't let me get back. I didn't really do in the command phase, though. The chaplain ate it. The Fenrisian wolves are coming up the board this way to assist. And here come a couple of dreads. And Murderfang. I'm probably not gonna survive his attacks, but if I can, I'm not in a bad spot with those possessed over there. But it's not looking good. And then we're right to shooting. 3 bolt pistols. And 1 miss. And 1 wound, AP 1. 3 up. 4 up, I mean. That's 1 damage.
All right, down you go.
Stormbolter into the blitz.
Yep. I'm just gonna quickly roll some saves. We're good. We make all our saves. Heavy flamer into Bjorn from Bjorn. Boop. 4 and 3 wounds. -1. These are 3 ups. These ones I'll actually take a damage. Then that's kind of it for shooting.
I see.
Charging Murderfang definitely wants to charge in. That's the sound choice there. He makes it. All right, here comes the big guy. 1 of 3 dreadnoughts. Those dreadnoughts are going to hold a line and force me to have to deal with them. Because I'm charging in, they have, I have 4 up in vulnerable saves. They'll take mortal wounds on Cursed Earth as you charge in. So I think I like them holding there better anyways. They could do a lot. It's a gamble. It's a big gamble. I usually gamble, but maybe holding. I also don't love the idea of them charging in. I don't really know what the right call there is. Oh, you can shoot the Hellfrost gun. We forgot the Hellfrost gun.
Oh, yeah, we forgot the Hellfrost gun.
Big shot. Pew! Hit. And pretty high strength. That's probably good enough to wound. I have an embalm, which I'm gonna fail. My gosh. That's like a lot of damage, too.
D3 plus 3.
That obliterator is just gonna eat it. So
yeah,
that
might be -4.
That might make the charge more interesting. We're gonna charge the Wolf and Dreadnought in there, see what happens, and test the waters. And, six makes it on its own, I guess. We really need the second die. Boom. We're not gonna allow the Dark Apostle to heroically intervene, though. A 2 up, you take a mortal wound. You do. I have 7 wounds left. Do you want to charge in the wolves to help out?
Yes, I was going to charge them to go over here.
Oh, big guy there? Yeah, go for it.
Yeah, just to stuff.
10!
Want it.
In it to win it. Okay, that should be it for charging. No armor of rust to worry about. You just get to... I don't have enough to interrupt, so you can start fighting wherever you want, really.
Okay.
You want to do the wolves?
Yeah, we'll get the wolves out of the way.
Up and around, all 10 wolves are attacking. And then, yeah, we're going to use 2 command points on pack hunters here, because they are currently engaged, because they're within 2 of... That? No, not within 1 inch of... dang. I think we're still technically engaged, so it does work here, because you're within 2 of the defense line, and he's, you know, within 1 of it, or base in contact with it even. So yeah, plus, what this means is, because he's engaged with them, in the charge phase, when they charge for 2 command points, they get to reroll wound rolls against him, because it's pack hunters. But they're little wolves, so we'll see what they can do. 16 attacks. They get +1 to hit. And all the 6s help out as well. These are 5s to wound with rerolls. And the reroll. 1, 2, 3 more. Involve and saves because we're near the cursed earth. That means you take a mortal wound, actually. These are AP2, right?
It's AP1. It's
up to 2 because
of Yeah.
Okay, so I take 5 wounds. I have 1 wound left. He almost died. And then on a 2 up, you take no mortal wounds. I forgot to do it. Cursed earth, though. This cursed earth is a longer, bigger range. Cannot believe he almost died to a pack of wolves. You'll get to go next with the wolf and dreadnought. So he is going to use the big damage swing, which is -1 to hit. He's back to hitting on 3s, only 1 hit.
But then reroll for Bjorn.
Yes. Oh, he's not core, though. Ideal. Definitely going to wound on a 2 or a 3, not a 1. Wolf and Dreadnought just scuffed it. He just screwed the bed there.
He definitely wolfed on that one.
All right, we got the Murder Claw.
Murder Fang.
Murder Fang next. 8 attacks, hitting on 2s. Everything hits +1. Probably wound on 3s or 2s, and I believe he gets to reroll. And rerolling, we got 4 wounds so far. I need to survive, but it's not likely. 3 more. Roll like a god here. I dropped the die on the ground. Oh, that's probably them all dead. Because are these 3 each or 2? I never use them, actually.
3.
Oh, yeah, they're all dead. Oh, no. All right. Well, a series of unfortunate events. I will go with my champion there. Demon Blade. Oh, 2 more hits. That's pretty good. And 3s. All right, well, 3 wounds. Those are, and you'll take 2 mortal wounds after everything is said and done as well. These are -3 or -2. Don't roll 5s, and I won't have to look, because I don't want to look. Thank you. So I kill 3. Oh, he just cuts all of the Astartes up, then 2 more mortal wounds, but there's nothing there. So I will just consolidate. The one champion lives. And then I'll go with the Venom Crawler. Get out of the way. You charged me. Rerolls. So these all hit, and these are 2s to kill a wolf. So I kill 6 wolves. Never mind, I only kill 5 of the wolves. There's 3 left. And that will be it for there. These obliterators were base contact there. This one's gonna pile in a little bit. This one, do I want him to? No. They're gonna hang out right there. Just gonna attack that, guys. 8 attacks into the dreadnought. They roll very well to kill the dreadnought here. You charge me, so I'm hitting on that with a reroll. We got 1 more hit in there. These are 3s to wound. It's not a bad roll, but not enough to kill you. So you're gonna have 6 invulns. 6 invulnerable saves. You are gonna take 2 damage. He's got 5 wounds left because you reduce all the damage by 1. Each one of those is 2 damage. Not an ideal fight for them. That's it. You owe me a morale check on those 3 wolves.
4.
Yeah, they're not ideal. They're good. There's a great example of 9th edition leadership. It's 500 guys. You have a 1-in-6 chance of automatically passing morale. And then we forgot to consolidate Murder Fang. He'll go. This alone is probably the end of the game for me here, because I cannot do anything about this. I am going to have to... I have a plan to try and stake my way out of it, but I'm going to have to roll amazing. Otherwise, that is it. I am... Oh, sorry. You are going to score a tempting target. Oh, no. I can't do actually stop tempting target, because he rolled really well. That's why that was good, because he killed all the obsec on the unit and lived. Therefore, it is my objective, so tempting target was not accomplished. I do deny that, but you do kill one of my units for grinding down, which means I get mine, but I have to kill one of your units to stop yours, which I already did, I guess, technically, so I prevented your grinding down, but there's no point in getting rid of it because it goes away at the end of my turn anyways, and you're halfway to defending Stronghold. I cannot stop that. You're going to get that no matter what as we go into my turn 4. Yeah, then Rob's going to get rid of a tempting target because that is not going to work out. But I do score, like I said, my grinding down, so that'll help me draw 3 cards on my turn. I'm going to get 10 points this turn because that one champion with 1 wound left did me damn good justice. Okay, so I'm at 3 secondary to your 5, so I'm down by 10 points there, and I'm down by 20 points on primary. We got a lot of ground to cover. All right, we are going to try out a few things. We're going to cast Illusory Supplication on himself because he needs to work. But I do get to reroll because I'm a Word Bearer, Dark Apostle. We do make it. So he essentially chants on a 2-up rerollable, and then he's going to go Omen of Potency. We're good there. Okay. That is it for my... I technically score, so I got that objective and this objective. That's where my 10 points come from. I obviously don't have more than Space Wolves. That'd be impossible to accomplish. I have to kill you, and then I have to kill you. On to the movement phase. I am going to do a couple of things here. I got to help out that Venom Crawler. I'm going to probably just keep that guy there and not do too much with him. I can't risk losing him. These guys are going to stay in combat because they kind of have to. The Dark Apostle is going to move forward and deal with Bjorn. We're going to have a legendary character fight here, but it's not my favorite because Bjorn's toughness 8, I believe. I'm strength 5 up to strength 7, so I'm only wounding you on 5s. He's going in. They're going to stay where they are. I am going to keep this last hand team can move a little bit. They can just get slightly better line of sight. And this guy heals a wound in the command phase. He's up to 2. He almost died twice. Okay, this guy is gonna advance. He needs to roll a bonkers high advance roll. A 1 is not bonkers high. I need a command point to reroll that run roll. Okay, well, thank you, game, for griefing the crap out of me. So I needed him to advance to here to smite him for the, and then among other things. But we're gonna roll a 1. Twice! That's gonna, he's just gonna end up going there. So he won't be able to see him, so he'll just smite the Murder Fang. Can't quite get to the character, sadly. That should be it for my movement. We are gonna go into the psychic phase, and we're gonna start with a smite. We are gonna fail that. And then we are gonna cast Cursed Earth, which we succeed. And then we're gonna cast Pact of Flesh, which we succeed. I failed Cursed Earth. because I rolled a 6. Pact of Flesh succeeds, though. I get to bring one of these guys back. They heal D3 wounds, and then afterwards, if they're not at their full strength, they come back with a model. Boom. And we'll bring one of the models back. Okay, that's it for a psychic. We're going to go on to shooting. I don't even know what to say, what to do here. This is all pretty scuffed. We are going to go ahead and fire our Venom Crawler into combat. Shots into the wolves, all of this ones. We have another hit in there because of the 6. It is an assault weapon. 3's to wound. All the wolves dead. They're minus 2 damage each. The wolves get punked. Boom, 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 boom. You guys are dead. Forgot to move them back. They're going to be at the very back of this objective. Want to be within 3 of the objective and as far away from Murder Fang as possible, but I can't do much about it. Okay, well, I am going to go on to the rest of my shooting. These last games are going to fire into Murder Fang, I guess. I got 4 of them. They all hit. That's a good start. 3's to wound. 2 of them get through. I'm going to save my command points because I'm going to need them. And you got a 6-up save on Murder Fang. 2 of them. Minus 3. Can his armor? Ooh, both go through. 1 at a time because I could reroll. That's 2 damage. And that's 1. That's 3 damage. Probably 5 wounds left. They can fire their weapons in melee. They're going to fire at the Wolf and Dreadnought, but they're all -1 to hit. I'm going to do the D3 shot weapon. So it's going to be, ooh, a little bit less, 5 shots. Hit on 4s. Call 3 hits, not bad, not bad. 3's to wound because it's good strength. 1 save. 4 up invulnerable. Oh, nice. Does 3, it's D3 plus 3 damage. So it's 4, 3 damage with a negative. Wolf and Dreadnought's got 2 remaining wounds. They're running charging. Just the chaplain charging Bjorn, I guess. Screw it. Bjorn is, of course, going to Overwatch.
First.
Heavy Flamer. D6 automatic hits. It'll be 1. And it's going to... Does it even wound? It does. Put it on the little guy. They have 4 up invulns. They're okay. And then we got the big gun. 6 to hit. No. And I will charge 4. It's all up to chaplain kick butt. And that's my only charge because this guy advanced. And then we're done. We're on to fighting. And I'm just going to fight with the Dark Apostle. The 8-fold Curse Crozius kind of flounders here. So 2's to hit. I'm going to reroll everything so I didn't get any 6s. Greedy. Oh, the greed did not work out there. I got, oh, gross. I need a lot. I need like extreme luck to kill Bjorn here. That's why I went for that. I need to roll a bunch of 6s. Oh, that's a fail. I need 5s to wound him. 3 go through. That's not bad. These are AP 4, so he doesn't have a, unless he's got a 2-up. 6 damage on him. He's only got a 3-up armor save, but he has a 5-up to shrug damage. He's got 5-ups to ignore the damage. Legendary Tenacity. He only takes 3. Has 5 remaining wounds, I believe. And then you get to pick the fight, probably the Wolf and Dreadnought. 4 attacks on the Wolf and Dread now, hitting on 4s with a -1 to hit, because no +1 in a prolonged combat. And then these are 2 or 3 to wound. Round 1 again. He did the exact same thing. We're just going to stay there and attack him back. I also get no charge rolls, so I just have 12 attacks at you. All right, these are 3s to hit, no rerolls. These miss. That's a in the hole. Didn't do anything. I'll keep the 1 there because I got a 6. These are 3s to wound the Wolf and Dreadnought with my punchy hands. With my punchy hand. With my punch. There we go. Nice. All right. 1 fail. That is 8 saves. 8 4-ups. You take 4 damage. Do you explode? In the end, 1 final little... No. Punch the Wolf and Dreadnought out of commission. We could consolidate. I am too small-brained right now to figure out where I want to go, so I'm not even going to bother. I think I've lost. Mathematically. Okay. That is, Bjorn gets to fight back. 5, 1 more hit in there because of the 6.
Oh, yep, yep, yep.
And then these are going to be 3, or even 2's to win probably, with a reroll. Yep, 5 saves. Invulns! 4 ups! I make 3 of them. Unfortunately, these 2 kill my 2 little homies.
How much each?
They only have 1 wound. They just die.
Okay.
Alright, that's it. We're at a standstill. So Bjorn kills 2 little acolytes, and the Dark Apostle is there happy and swinging. Unfortunately, I don't really get much done there. I realized I totally forgot to show you guys what my secondary missions were. That's why I didn't really... That's why I'm like, oh, I lost this game, because I have nothing to really do here. Can't do cash for enemy outposts, can't do deploy teleport homer, and no retreat, no surrender. I can do, but it's only worth the 1. So I score that at the end of Rob's turn. So at the end of my turn, I'm getting rid of both of these. No retreat, no surrender. That's also why I didn't really fall back too much, nor did I leave any of the objectives. We are on a turn 5, where Rob is going to score max primary, because he gets another 10 points for the sticky objective the Space Marines have. Don't even need that one in the corner. You're at 40 out of 45. So a quick look at the score, max primary, and then you do get defense stronghold at the end of my turn. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, six. You're at six scored secondaries. You can score up to three more secondaries on this last turn of the game, which is where we're currently at. And I'm at three, so I have to do... I can't even get max on that. And I can't get max on... Interesting. Actually, looking at it, if my turn goes perfectly, I will get 35 on that, which means I'll be down 10 here. And then if I get all three of my secondaries, I'll be at tying you. So no matter what, if my turn's perfect, I still lose the game. So I'll throw in the towel there, and I guess we'll call it.
Before you head on into the post-game, don't forget that in the Mini Wargaming Vault, there is a match play battle report between Archon Skari himself and Adam Camilleri, who's come all the way from the land down under to play some games. Make sure you check it out. There is a 7-day free trial if you haven't tried it already for all the cool stuff in the vault. But before you do that, watch the post-game.
All right, we figured we'd just jump right into a post-game here, because you win, like, even if I get a perfect turn, you still win by 10 points. So, okay. Overall, though, pretty damn good game.
I agree.
You get a near max score of Space Wolves. Even though the first turn were kind of scuffed on the cards, I gambled way too much with my... That ultimately led to my downfall, is I gambled a little bit too long with my cards, and then I didn't see the waves and waves of Space Wolves coming in that were going to be denying me those cards that I kept. Now, the other two things that led to that was when you heroically intervened with the chaplain and I had my possessed in there, not killing both of them was critical for me. You made like 7 out of 9 saves on him or something like that, and I needed you to fail the average for him to die to kill both of them. That was huge because then he killed two of them back, which means you could threaten my objective back here. And then when he came in, he didn't kill enough of the possessed, so I could have like fought with this a little bit more. I could have dealt with that. Then the possessed could have been scoring this on the end too, which might have helped me with the cards. In hindsight, it would not have mattered because none of my cards were relevant for this objective. That's good. And then in the middle here, when I failed that 6-inch charge, because had I made that charge, it would have been a 5-point swing both ways every turn, because I would have been controlling. I would have been controlling that objective in the middle, it looked like, with how the combats were going to be going. Instead of us fighting over here, we would have been fighting on top of that the entire time. And then this would have been your side still, but then I eventually won out on that side. So it would have been like a push in the middle, that would have been dicey, but that would have been my flank and this would have been your flank. So a nice even game, but instead of me fighting back here and over here, we would have been fighting on the objective where I could have potentially scored it all those turns. That was on, I think that was on like turn 2 as well.
Right.
Yeah. So that would have been an extra 15 points. That would have made the game a little bit closer. That was the crux. That 6-inch charge potentially lost me the game. But that's what my gut told me at that point too. Usually I get like, I'm like, oh, game's over. But hey, I'm recording content, so I gotta play with the rest of it. You never know.
You were definitely coming back at the end there. So I mean, I was starting to sweat a little bit.
Yeah.
Because if I don't know if we played it out, and I don't know, some critical saves that could have not happened, and you probably would have started taking things back.
I needed that 6-inch charge real bad. Now, granted, the alternate list I was going to build without the Obliter wouldn't have mattered either, because it would have been dropping him. He's 90 points. 20-point upgrade for Marcus Lanesh on him. Then I had 70 points to put elsewhere, which would have been one more unit of cultist. I couldn't. I had six troops. Oh, I could do more. I could do 9 troops. I would have had one more unit of cultists, I believe, yeah, because they would have allowed me to take the extra one. It was 3 legionaries, 3 cultists. They would have been, yeah, it would have just been that and like another 20-point upgrade somewhere dumb and pointless. Maybe a mark on like one of the legionary units. That's all the major difference would have been, but I'm happy to see none of that would have actually really mattered. In hindsight. Great game though, dude. That was
a great game.
Yeah. it was perfect. It was very bloody, exactly what I wanted, and I liked the fighting on the bridges. How'd you like the table? It was a little bit different.
No, I love the table. I mean, we don't have this back where we usually play in our play group, so I mean, the fact that we had the elevation, the interaction of the different terrain pieces, I really liked it.
I thought, I had a lot of fun. I miss these higher raised boards. I'll be playing, I don't know what you guys think. It's not perfect for, not all games is perfect, because then you can block, I guess that's not true, because you can block lanes. There's like this unique, but then again, you can make this table where this section is like over here out of the game. But I like having that. The bridges were important. I played a game of the Heresy on this the other day too, which is quite fun. And I'm looking forward to making a lot more boards with a lot more elevation and three dimension to it, essentially. And so, the neoprene mats are great and convenient, but I've gotten a little complacent with them, so I've been getting a little lazy, so I want to play with the bigger, nicer boards. Excellent game. Everything I did worked, and everything you kind of did worked. Right. So, like, there was no real feel bads, because you had some pretty heavy whiffs also,
right,
in a lot of regards. So, like, it's not like my double six lost me the game. There's lots of moments where your bad rolls could have cost you the game, too.
Right.
But it was, like, just enough. It was just enough to take you over the edge. Because, again, had I gone... I think the only difference would have been a 10-point score, maybe more if you got secondaries you could have done here. And that's a good game because we both had a good score too. It was, you had the early score and I was coming back in the end.
Right.
Beautiful space wolves too, by the way.
Thank you.
Yeah, there's a lot of work put into these, I could tell.
Thank you.
Excellent. Like, especially, I love that wolf priest,
the chaplain
on the bike. Excellent there. When did you start collecting the wolves?
This is the first army I've ever started collecting for 40K. So this was starting back in 2017. And just slowly I've been painting it up. I've split my time between that, Death Watch, and a couple other projects I painted for you guys once for things. And
what'd you end up doing for us?
It was a unit or two of a couple Stormcast units.
Okay, fair. Yeah.
But yeah, no, I mean, I love the painting more than the gaming. So, I mean, I put my love into the...
That's fair.
Pain inside of it.
I always find, like, there's three major parts to the game. There's the playing, collecting, and I always put converting into painting.
Right.
Kind of. Because, like, even, like, your Blade Guard veterans had swapped heads.
Yes.
Right? Yeah. There's a few other things that had swapped heads. So that's, like, a conversion, right? So I always convert. Hobbying, I'll call it, I suppose. Yeah. Usually people only really appreciate two aspects of it. It's rare to find someone that's into all three. And when I say collecting, I mean, like, big time collecting. Like, you have, like, every army you have is like minimum 5,000 points. So, like, are you into the collecting part of it, more playing?
For Marines, I probably definitely have over 5,000 points worth. Tau is probably close to that.
Okay.
I'm a little bit of a collector, also.
Would you say the playing is the least interesting? You'll do it, but it's like, eh.
No, I mean, I love to play. Like, I love to hang out with my friends and whatnot, but I mean, I'm kind of split between, but, you know, the hobbying component, you know, goes far and above.
Gotcha, okay. I find, most people skew into two aspects of the game. I cannot stand the hobby aspect of it, if I'm to be honest. I can paint, I know how to paint, I like my painting style, and I've converted things in the past, I've had fun with it, but I just don't have the patience for it. Every time I find myself doing it, I get aggravated. So I try to, like, I'm like, you know what, I have a lot more fun playing and collecting. I get excited for new pieces, how I can use them on my lists, and I like to see obviously I like to play the game.
Right.
It'd be kind of weird if I didn't. I get a little jaded. I won't lie, if I'm going to be transparent. Like, I get, you know, this is maybe my, like, 342nd game of 9th edition. It's not actually that much, but, like, it gets up there, right? But it's fun. This was a damn good game. I like Tempest of War. I like this table. And 1,500 points feels like a good level for 40K these days. I hate to admit it, because in-house, Steve's been, like, trying to convince me for, I kid you not, 4 years. We played a little bit of 8th edition, and then they did the first points adjustment in 8th edition, where they made the weaker armies a lot cheaper.
Right.
And then he said, man, just play 1,500 points, because then it's like everything feels a lot better. I'm like, no way, dude, this game's meant to play 2K. Yadi is stubborn as an ox, dude, on that one.
Right.
And then now, finally, 4 years later, they did another point drop. I'm like, I'm done, dude. 1,500 points is what 40K feels good to play at, because at 1,500 points, now assume they do another drop, then you know, we're talking about like 1250 or whatever, but 1500 points, it's hard to pick what you want to add to your army, right? And then say I had a big thing, like say I had a 2000 point game, if you don't hide everything, it's annihilated right away, because everyone has so many options. I find with 1500 point games, it's like, okay, in a 2000 point game, these two units are gonna delete that unit, these two units are gonna delete that unit. Now in a 1500 point game, you might be missing one of those four units. So all of a sudden you have to commit one of those odd units to a direction, all of a sudden that might whiff, that might fail, you might make the wrong call, the dice might not go your favor. The consistency drops significantly. All the decisions are a lot harder overall. So I would recommend, if you guys are kind of feeling burnt out on 40K, you want it to feel fresh again, and you want big moments to happen where, like, little guys have a bigger impact on the game, 1,500 points is where you're going to thrive. Like, look at those wolves, dude. They almost one-shot a Venom Crawler, and that's massive in a smaller scale game where I lose, like, that much. Things like that, like a little dreadnought can commit so much control over a section of the battlefield. Five Lascans are scary. Like, it's all of a sudden, like...
I was scared of them.
Yeah, exactly.
I was like, oh no, how bad is this going to go?
that's the thing, dude. It's just like all these little components are like, you then, like, three Thunderwolf Cavalry just came up and smashed through the lines, and then they went down. Then two characters smashed through my line. It was like all these little things matter so much more. Every little cultist you have left matters more too. Like, I know you're thinking, it's only 500 points, how much could it be? It adds, it's a lot. Like, that's a lot more, like 500 points. Like, that's two more units of obliterators if I wanted, like, essentially. I could have, well, granted, like, they're 270, but, like, I can make 40 points somewhere, right?
Right.
That's, just to give you an example, I could have six more obliterators. Like, that's a lot more consistent, right? You could have three redemptors, and more. You have three redemptors and more in that 500 points. Yeah. Imagine this list had three redemptors in it, guys. That's what I'm talking about. Like, it's nuts. That 500 points adds up to a lot. Anyways, I'll call it there. because I want to go drink some water. I've been talking a lot, and I want to give a big thanks to Rob for the game. That was an excellent game. And again, a reminder, go check out their stuff at Team Drew's Basement. We got Drew from Team Drew's Basement just a few doors down playing some Heresy with Steve. You're going to be seeing some content with him as well. So if you watch both channels, hopefully you get the excitement of that. And if not, go check them out. They're in the description down below. You can redirect to where they do the Warhammer, Dungeons & Dragons, nerdery across the board. They got a lot of stuff going on there. Happy Wargaming, everyone. Toodaloo.